The following is an exclusive presentation of Jessup Broadcasting, the sports leader in Southeast Georgia.
Feel the power
of Yellow Jacket Baseball.
Pitch, runner going, ground ball, hit the second base, and by second baseman in the center field, runner hit the third, they're going to wave him.
Boom, 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 boom.
Yellow Jacket Baseball, presented in part by Jones Medical Equipment, Mighty Body Shop, Damon's Famous Fingers and Wings, Wayne Memorial Hospital, Sheffield's Trophy and Sports Shop, Mobile Concrete, State Farm Agent Robin Eubanks, Sheriff John Carter, Boykin Steel and Crane, Hog and Bone, April Banks Remax, Prime South Bank, The Interstate Credit Union, Tim's Home Medical, Top Notch Lawn Care, Hurricane's Convenience Store, Vegan Air Co., The Altima Hospital Credit Union, and Design Landscaping.
Now, the legendary voice of the Yellow Jackets, Bob Morgan.
Vidalia, another exciting season of Wayne County Yellow Jacket Baseball about to kick off here on Big Dog Country FM 105.5. 30-game schedule, home and away games all on the Big Dog. It all starts with the scrimmage tonight. They had the fun day Saturday. Field's in good shape after the Vandals destroyed it, but a lot of work was put in by a lot of people, and I tell you, you couldn't tell it was vandalized, and that's a good thing. It looks awfully very nice here for this scrimmage. Wayne County starting lineup is in. Coach McDonald has Cooper Martin leading off at short. Griffin Boykin at second, batting second. David Mosley bats third in the DH spot for center fielder Blake Wood. Batting cleanup, Zach Thomas at third base. Batting sixth, Ty Anderson at first base. Batting seventh will be Jacob Brewer, the catcher. Blake Wood is being batting forward in the third spot.
At this time, we
Zach Thomas batting cleanup at third base. Ty Anderson batting fifth at first base. Jacob Brewer sixth at catcher. Jasper Stanfield batting seventh in left. Bryce Miller, pitcher, bats for himself at eighth. And Ham Perkins will bat ninth and play right field. They're getting ready for the national anthem, so we'll take a break. Be right back here on Big Dog Country, FM 105.5.
Top Notch Lawn Care is here to serve your lawn and land needs. We offer everything from yearly contracts to one-time cleanups. Has your yard gotten out of hand? Let Top Notch Lawn Care give your property the attention it deserves. Call 912-271-3368.
For all your lawn care needs, call my daddy, Joey Scarborough, at 912-271-3368. Dad,
check it! Heating and Air Co. for all your heating and air needs. We install the best and service the rest. 912-427-COOL, your hometown American Standard dealer.
Hey, Robbie, why American Standard?
Well, Jonathan, for the last 8 years in a row, American Standard Heating and Air Equipment has been number one in Consumer Reports as the most reliable system made, which makes it the best. That's why.
Makes sense to me, Robbie. How do I schedule my free replacement estimate?
Just call 912-427-COOL. Georgia license number CR110318.
Hurricane's Convenience Store and Cafe invites everyone to stop by before or after the game. It's a one-stop store with just about everything you need to get through the day. Whether it's a fill-up with gasoline or a snack or a delicious breakfast Monday through Friday at Hurricane's Cafe, yes, Hurricane's is that one-stop shop convenience store and is ready to serve you. Hurricane's is locally owned and operated by the Twilley family. Ron and the gang invite you to stop by. If you need to call, the number is 912-294-2276. It's Hurricane's, a hurricane you run to and not from. Hurricane's Convenience Store and Cafe, ready to serve you.
Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup is your full-service medical equipment provider for Southeast Georgia. We accept most insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, TRICARE, and Blue Cross Blue Shield. We offer 24-hour on-call service. Come see us for your respiratory needs, including oxygen and CPAP. Plus, we have the equipment to get you back on your feet, from beds to scooters to walkers and more. And we offer a full line of scrubs. Come see our friendly staff. Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup and Brunswick. Your quality of life is our business.
Does your car or truck need a paint job, body repair, or even a tow? Call the experts at Lightsey's Body Shop, family owned and operated since 1978, where the courteous, knowledgeable, and professional staff will meet all your needs at Lightsey's Body Shop, where everybody is somebody. Call us today. Let us take the stress away. We are located at 1526 Rainier Road, just past the dollar store. Give us a call at 385-6193. That's 385-6193. Lightsey's Body Shop.
Stateman's Restaurant is open 7 days a week and offers daily specials and has a wide variety of menu items from salads to wings to burgers and fries, and check out their famous turkey burger. Stateman's is famous for their variety of sauces, mild, wild, insane, or inferno. When it comes to party platters, Stateman's can make your party special. Simply call in the order ahead of time by calling 588-WING, 588-9464. Stateman's Famous Fingers and Wings continues to please its customers, and if you're looking for a great meal any day of the week, stop by and enjoy Stateman's. You can stop in or use the drive-thru at the location 336 West Cherry Street. That's Stateman's Restaurant, a Wayne County favorite.
County Baseball brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095, 427-2095.
Welcome back. We are set for the scrimmage here at Howard Bowen Field. Bob Morgan with you on Big Dog 105.5. The lineup for Vidalia: Garrett Gillis leads off in center. Dawson Ricks bats second and third. The pitcher, Landry Mead, bats third. Michael Blunt will bat cleanup at first base. Carson McClellan will bat fifth and right. Hughes Graham bats sixth, does the catching. Matt Boyer will bat seventh to play second. Caden Spivey bats eighth and short. And Bryce Davis will bat ninth and play left field. And for Wayne County, Cooper Martin leads off. He'll be at short. Griffin Boykin bats second and second base. David Mosley will bat third, be the DH for the center fielder, Blake Wood. Batting cleanup, Zach Thomas on third base. Ty Anderson bats fifth in first base. Jacob Brewer bats sixth at catcher. Jasper Stanfield bats seventh at left. Batting eighth, the pitcher, Bryce Miller on the mound. And Hamp Perkins at left, or in right field, batting ninth. First pitch by Bryce Miller, laced down the right field, but foul. Just foul. Missed the chalk as leadoff batter. Garrett Gillis, center fielder, leadoff batter for the Vidalia Indians. Again, a scrimmage with Vidalia, then we're in action Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. That's the next game, first regular season ball game, 6 o'clock start down at Brunswick High School. Bryce Miller is one pitch up high. So defensively for Wayne County, to start the scrimmage, you got Zach Thomas down at third base, Cooper Martin at short, Griffin Boykin at second, and Ty Anderson at first base. Jacob Brewer behind the plate. Ground ball right side. Griffin Boykin's got it on the first in time. One up, one down for the Vidalia Indians here in the first inning. Your outfield to start for Wayne County, and right field, Hamp Perkins.
Dawson Ricks.
Center fielder, Blake Wood. And in left field is Jasper Stanfield. That's your starting lineup for the scrimmage here to start inning number one. We'll see a lot of players before the night is through. Pitches way up high, ball one. Varsity roster, Sean Steverson, Blake Wood, Brennan Lee, Blake Brockington, Trey Pierce, Ty Anderson, Griffin Boykin, Luke Boykin, J.C. Williams, Cooper Martin, Miles Starling, Zach Thomas, Hamp Perkins, Bryce Miller, Ray Townsend, Brad Arati, Tyler Dennison, Gant Starling, Jasper Stanfield, Jacob Brewer, and David Mosley. Here's the wind, the 1-0 pitch, swinging a miss, strike one. Coaches, Justin McDonald, head coach, assistants, Jordan Mullis, Barrett Browning, Mike Roberts, Colt Brockington, Buddy Starling, and the statistician this year is Adriana Mark. Swing and a miss, strike two. The batter is Dawson Ricks, the third baseman for the Vidalia Indians. Just underway at the scrimmage. Good crowd on hand here at Howard Bow. Lights are on. Bryce Miller's 1-2 pitch. Up high, ball two, 2-2. Bryce's senior year, getting signed a scholarship, play for Augusta University. No, they don't have Two balls, two strikes, one down, nobody on. The pitch, swing and a miss, and Bryce has his first strikeout here in the scrimmage, and it's two up, two down for the Vidalia Indians. I want to thank our sponsors, and we'll run down those during the course of the season.
And of course,
don't have their list with me tonight, but just put it all together today, but we'll have that for you Monday in Brunswick, Georgia. But we do want to thank our sponsors for allowing us to be here to bring this live play-by-play. Chopper to third, Zach Thomas in quickly, throws to first in time. Quickly, three up, three down for the Vidalia Indians. In the inning, no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. We go to the bottom of the first in the scrimmage. It's Vidalia 0, Wayne County coming to bat.
Wayne Memorial Hospital wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck as they pursue region and state championships. The hard work and dedication of our coaches and student athletes has been instrumental to your success. The staff at Wayne Memorial Hospital is also dedicated to providing and delivering the best possible health care to everyone who comes through our doors. We consider it an honor and a privilege to be entrusted with your health care needs. Caring for the community isn't just our motto, it's what we love to do. Wayne Memorial Hospital, the official health care provider of the Yellow Jackets.
At Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors. Custom landscape design, including sod installation, shrubs and trees, bedding plants, unique hardscapes, seating areas, fire pits, archway entrances, and pavers. Design Landscaping can also do sprinkler systems, fencing, and more. Call Ryan Madry at Design Landscaping, 678-347-6136, 678-347-6136. On Facebook, Design Landscaping, Instagram, Design_Landscaping. Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors.
Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop is proud to be sponsoring Wayne County Yellow Jacket Baseball and wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck this baseball season. Sheffield's has all your Under Armour winter and cold gear as they are the new Under Armour provider in this area. Sheffield's has all you need to outfit your team, bats, balls, caps, jackets, you name it, they've got it. Sheffield's is located 1516 West Orange Street and has everything you need when it comes to sporting goods. Stop by or give them a call today. The number is 427-2982. Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop wishing the Yellow Jackets the best of luck all season.
Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Southeast Georgia Garage Door. Call 266-6567, 266-6567, Southeast Georgia Garage Door.
We got the bottom first for the Yellow Jackets. Number 14, shortstop Cooper Martin.
Bottom of the first, Cooper Martin leads it off for Wayne County. He'll be followed by Griffin Boykin and David Mosley. David Mosley in the DH slot again. I understand he's got a shoulder injury right now, doing some rehab on the shoulder as far as throwing the ball behind the plate, but he is able to swing a bat, so he's playing DH tonight for Wayne County. Pitcher on the mound for Vidalia is Landry Mead. First pitch is in for a strike. No balls, one strike. Cooper swings and fouls it straight back. Quickly, no balls and two strikes. The leadoff batter, Cooper Martin, in for his senior year. And they tell us we're going to see him on the mound a little bit this year. Looking forward to that. He pitched an inning in the fun day. But again, reliable shortstop, leadoff hitter, looking for a big senior year. The 0-2 pitch, down low, ball one, 1-2. Griffin Boykin on deck, again, then David Mosley, batting for center fielder Blake Wood, then it's gonna be Zach Thomas in that cleanup spot at third base, Ty Anderson at first base, Jacob Brewer behind the plate, Jasper Stanfield's in left, Bryce Miller on the mound, and Ham Perkins in a right field. The 1-2 pitch to Cooper, a little low, ball two. Two balls and two strikes. Just underway here at the scrimmage, Wayne County Vidalia, good crowd on hand to check out the Wayne County baseball team. Again, Coach Justin McDonald at third, Jordan Mullis at first base in the coach's box. Cooper hits it foul and out of play. The count remains two balls and two strikes. Just underway here in the bottom of the first, game scheduled for 7. And as Jonathan stated all week, we're going to probably see Johnny Holstaff on the mound. Coach McDonald and Mullis want to look at as many pitchers as they can in the scrimmage before they head into regular season play down in Brunswick, Georgia. Still weeks away from the region schedule. The region schedule, again, will be that Monday, Wednesday, Friday format. Cooper again laces it, but laces it foul down the left field line and out of play. Two balls, two strikes game just underway here in the bottom of inning number one, Wayne County and Vidalia. Vidalia in a white pants and kind of a maroon jersey. Pitch is down low, and Cooper's run it to 3-2. 3-2, Landry Mead, right-hander for Vidalia. Payoff pitch will be due to leadoff batter Cooper Martin, number 14 on his jersey. Payoff pitch, call, strike 3 on the corner, and there's one down. Good location on that pitch by me right there on the outside corner. Cooper decided to take it, and the umpire says strike 3.
Griffin Boykin.
Here's Griffin Boykin, another senior. The King the other night at homecoming. Griffin's had a heck of a year. Wendy's Heisman Award winner, King of the Court. Just an excellent student. Won the All-Academic Award at the football banquet for the fourth year in a row. I mean, this kid, all-around excellent student, athlete, great kid. Griffin Boykin, still remember the grand slam against Buford. The 0-1 pitch, and that's inside, ball one. 1-1. Just underway. Come join us. Plenty of good food and concession stand. Home Run Club running the concession stand, as always. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike 2, 1-2. Again, the dimensions, they don't have them up right now, but it's 400 to dead center, 330 in the alley, 300 down the lines here at Howard Bo Warren. And they'll have those up shortly. They were doing some remodeling on the fence and the lights. Still working on the lights. The lights are supposed to be here in a couple weeks. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss, and back-to-back strikeouts for Landry Mead, the right-hander, 2-2, and brings up Zach Thomas. I'm sorry, David Mosley, the DH. David Mosley in the 3 spot.
David Mosley.
Another senior. So 3 seniors to lead off the first here, 1, 2, and 3. David Mosley, a catcher, but again, having some issue with his shoulder and is going through some rehab, but they do have him swinging a bat. But unable to catch at this time, they tell us it could be several weeks before we see him behind the plate. The 1-0 pitch. Little chopper, going to be a tough play. Shortstop charging, not going to get David Mosley. Infield single for David. Good speed down the line. First hit of the scrimmage. Infield single for Wayne County. Brings up the cleanup hitter, Zach Thomas.
How about number 17, third baseman, Zach Thomas.
Again, Zach had an excellent year last year on the JV. Excellent hitter. I believe he's just a sophomore, is that right, Smiley? Can't, not good at math. 20, let's see. A sophomore, that's what I thought, sophomore. They got the year, but they got the year they graduate, 2022, so I guess that is sophomore year. There's a one hopper to second, they flip to short in time, and the inning comes to a close. In the inning, Wayne County comes up empty, no runs. One hit, no errors, one man left on base. We played one at the bow in the scrimmage. It is Wayne at 0, Vidalia 0.
Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue now open 823 North 1st Street, 6 a.m. until 9 p.m. 6 days a week. They offer dine-in and drive-thru for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. In addition, catering, delivery, and fundraisers. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue. Stop by or call 912-385-2657, 385-2657. For fast pickup service. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue supports Wayne County Baseball. Go Jackets!
Finding the right house starts with REMAX.com, featuring millions of properties just waiting to be called home. With all types of listings, we'll recommend what's right for you. That's the sign of a REMAX agent. Visit REMAX.com to find your home and agent now. Each office independently owned and operated.
Hey, this is April Banks, your local REMAX agent. If you're wanting to buy or sell a home, come see me or one of my agents at 123 West Cherry Street, downtown Jessup.
When you become a customer at Prime South Bank, you become part of a team that has your back and is with you every step of the way in achieving your financial goals. Our doors opened in 1891. 125 years later, we are still going strong. Prime South is constantly bringing innovative and convenient banking solutions to our growing communities. And our customers, well, they are the real MVPs. In the bank or on the field, Prime South's game face is always on for you. Prime South Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095, 427-2095.
Number 21, first baseman.
We'll head to the top of the second inning. It'll be 4-5 and 6-4 Vade against Bryce Miller. Michael Blunt, the first baseman, followed by Carson McClellan. And use Graham, the catcher. There's a line drive, one hopper to second base. Griffin Boykins got it, throws to first in time. There's one up, one down in the second inning here for the Vidalia Indians. Griffin Boykins again, steady at second base all throughout his career. One of the best fielding second basemen in the region, in the state, Griffin Boykins. Brings up Carson McClellan, the right fielder, right-handed batter. Bryce Miller getting a second inning work here. Didn't really throw a lot of pitches in the first. Went ground ball to second, strikeout, and ground ball to third. On for his second inning work here in the scrimmage. Right-hander, the pitch. Swung on and fouled straight back. No balls, one strike. Once again, just joining us defensively, it's Zach Thomas at third, Cooper Martin at short, Griffin Boykin at second, Ty Anderson at first, and Jacob Brewer behind the plate. And your outfield has Ham Perkins in the right. In left is Jasper Stanfield and Blake Wood in center. The 0-1 pitch from Bryce Miller. Breaking pitch in for strike two. No balls, two strikes. Yeah, they didn't let him throw any breaking pitches during the fun day. They told him they just wanted to throw nothing but fastballs and changeups. So that was the first breaking pitch we've seen by Bryce. He's got a good one. The 0-2 pitch. This one stays a little high, 1-2. Wayne County in their black and gold jersey, their white pants, black and gold cap with the WC on the front. The 1-2 from Bryce Miller. Another breaking pitch, and that is called strike three on the inside corner for a second strike out of the game. Two up, two down here in the top of the second for Vidalia. And it brings up the catcher, Hughes Graham.
And the number 18 catcher, Hughes Graham.
And the regular season gets underway Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. And that weekend will be in Hazelhurst for a doubleheader. Pitches in for a strike. Jones County and Jeff Davis, the opponents for Wayne over in Hazelhurst. No balls, one strike, two outs. The 0-1 pitch. Outside, ball one, 1-1. Again, the field looks good. Nice green grass. Again, they did a lot of work. And I mean a lot of work. I'm just hats off the staff, the maintenance staff, everybody that volunteered, the coaches do a lot of work. But again, it looks awfully nice here for the scrimmage with Vidalia. Still some work to do on the outside outfield fence. But one thing I did notice, they've raised the fence. It's a little bit higher in the outfield now than it was in years past. The 1-2 pitch up high, ball two, 2-2, 2-2. And still got the monster out in center field, 400 feet dead center. A 2-2 from Bryce Miller. Line, but right to Griffin Boykin at second base. And it's another 1-2-3 inning for Bryce Miller and the Yellow Jackets. In the inning, no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. Inning and a half in the book in the scrimmage. Score, Wayne 0, Vidalia 0.
Interstate Credit Union has all the ingredients you need of a financial institution, and we have 5 branch locations to serve you. You get the services you need, and your money stays here in the community. You can relax because you're doing business with people you know and people who know you. Membership is open to 10 counties. It's easy to join, so call, click, or stop by one of our 5 branch locations and become a member today. Member NCUA.
all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Duncan Auto Service, 566 West Cherry Street, Jessup. Call 385-2153, 385-2153.
Taking out the bottom second for the Yellow Jackets, number 9, first baseman, Ty Anderson.
We head to the second inning, bottom half. For Wayne County, it'll be Ty Anderson, Jacob Brewer, and Jasper Stanfield. Anybody gets aboard, the pitcher, Bryce Miller, bat. Fidelia has changed pitchers already. Dawson Ricks, the third baseman, comes to the mound for the second inning of work for Fidelia. Ty Anderson, left-handed batter for Wayne County, steps in. First pitch to him is upstairs, ball one. Ty Anderson, also a senior in this lineup. So we got a Cooper Martin senior, Griffin Boykin senior, David Mosley senior, Zach Thomas sophomore, Ty Anderson senior. On deck, Jacob Brewer. Not a lot of juniors in this class. Three, Jasper Stanfield, Sean Stevenson, J.C. Williams, and Jacob Brewer also in that sophomore class. No score, 2-1 count to Ty Anderson. Ty had a good year of football at the tight end position. The wind, the 2-1 pitch, swung on and missed. Strike two, 2-2. First two pitchers of Vidalia look pretty sharp. They're popping them in pretty good, throwing strikes. First pitcher got two strikeouts. 2-2 pitch here. Swung on and foul back. Then it stays 2-2. State of the Union address tonight. President, I believe it starts at 9 is what they tell me. So that'll be on all channels. Excuse me. 2-2. Blake Wood, the batter. I'm sorry, Ty Anderson, the batter. And the pitch outside, 3-2. It's Ty Anderson, the first baseman, Jacob Brewer, the catcher, Jasper Stanfield, the left fielder, and again, Bryce Miller in the cleanup spot. And Perkins down to number 9 spot. And it's going to be a leadoff walk to start the second. A runner on for Wayne County, nobody out. We'll see how Coach McDonald and Coach Mullis play it here in a second. With the catcher at the plate.
Number 15, catcher Jacob Brewer.
And Jacob Brewer handled all the JV duties last year at catcher. Good-looking kid behind the plate. Pitches up high, ball one, 1-0. A lot of talent in this baseball program, that's for sure. Coach McDonald, Coach Mullis feel confident about this team. Looking forward to a good year. Looking forward to bringing it to y'all here on Big Dog Country at 105.5. Again, 30-game schedule, home and away. Begins Monday in Brunswick. One ball, no strikes to Jacob Brewer. Ty Anderson leads it first. The pitch. Popped him up, infield, Pitcher says he's got it, and he does, right at the home plate area. Rod number one. One down. Here's Jasper Stanfield.
Jasper Stanfield.
And Jasper, one of the three juniors on the squad. Jasper, Sean Stevenson, J.C. Williams. Runner first, one down. Bottom of the second, no score in the scrimmage with Vidalia. Pitch down low, ball one. Bryce Miller, pitcher on deck. National signing day tomorrow, a big ceremony tomorrow, 10 o'clock at the high school auditorium. About 7 or 8 football players going to sign on the dotted line. Have all those details for you tomorrow in local sports. Pitch in for a strike, 1-1. Jasper Stanfield, right-handed batter for Wayne County. Ty Anderson still at first base. One down, bottom of the second, no score here at the boat. One ball, one strike. Dawson Ricks ready the pitch. Popped up, foul, and out of play. Count runs to one ball, two strikes. I got Braves baseball coming your way shortly. If you'd like to be a sponsor of Braves baseball, call your sales rep at the station. Sign you up. Get you the preseason games for free. Great package. Atlanta Braves baseball. Be here before you know it. The 1-2 pitch. Popped up foul territory. First baseman has it behind the bag for out number two. Two away. Brings up pitcher Bryce Miller.
Batting number 19, pitcher Bryce Miller.
See if they send Ty Anderson out with two down. Coach McDonald going through a lot of signs at that third base coach's box. Runner first, two away, no score here in the second. Stretching the pitch. Swing and a miss, strike one. No balls, one strike. No balls, one strike, the stretch, the pitch. Inside, 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs, runner first base, no score. Wayne County, Vidalia here in the scrimmage to kick off the season. The 1-1. Bryce lays down a bunt. Pitcher fields it. No one at first base. Go with infield hit. First base was charging. Pitcher off the mound charging. Pitcher fielded it, looked to throw, and there was no one there at the bag. Second baseman not where he should have been, so it's an infield hit. Runners at first and second, two down. Second hit in the game for Wayne.
Right fielder, Hamp Perkins.
And here's right fielder Hamp Perkins. Going to Piedmont College next year. I'm going to sign a letter grenade tomorrow. Runners lead first and second, the pitch. And Hamp hits a ground ball to third. Third baseman takes it unassisted to the third base bag. And that ends the inning. In the inning, Wayne comes up empty. No runs, an infield hit. No errors with strand two. We hit to a third inning in the scrimmage. Your score remains Wayne 0, Vidalia 0.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Top Notch Lawn Care is here to serve your lawn and land needs. We offer everything from yearly contracts to one-time cleanups. Has your yard gotten out of hand? Let Top Notch Lawn Care give your property the attention it deserves. Call 912-271-3368.
For all your lawn care needs, call my daddy, Joey Scarborough, at 912-271-3368. That's just it!
Heating and Air Co. for all your heating and air needs. We install the best and service the rest. 912-427-COOL, your hometown American Standard dealer.
Hey, Robbie, why American Standard?
Well, Jonathan, for the last 8 years in a row, American Standard Heating and Air Equipment has been number one in Consumer Reports as the most reliable system made, which makes it the best. That's why.
Makes sense to me, Robbie. How do I schedule my free replacement estimate?
Just call 912-427-COOL. Georgia license number CR110318.
Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Southeast Georgia Garage Door. Call 266-6567. 266-6567. Southeast Georgia Garage Door.
Top of the third inning, Ray Townsend on the mound for Wayne County. Another one of the Townsend kids in the Wayne County program, Ray Townsend. First pitch is a strike, second pitch is a strike. As he faces 7-8-9 here, Matt Moyer, the second baseman, the leadoff batter, in the third for Vidalia. Ray Townsend on the mound for Wayne County. No balls, two strikes. Ray Townsend, another one of the sophomores on this roster. Pitch down low, ball one, one and two. Let's see, we've seen Robert, we've seen Stan, Davis. I'm trying to think here, I'm missing somebody here. Ford, how could I miss Ford? Ford was excellent, and now Ray. I said Davis. So Ray's the last one, they tell us. Good looking kid though, good looking athlete, Ray Townsend. It's good to see these brothers on the team. Got Luke Boykin and Griffin Boykin. Got Miles Starlin, Gann Starlin. Little Max Boykin still to come. Two balls, two strikes. Ray Townsend, a sophomore pitcher on the mound here at inning number three. And Howard Bill Warren, the pitch up high, ball three. Had some great brother teams or tandems in the Wayne County history. Going all the way back to the Horton Twins, Jody and Jeff. Had some Palmer kids, brothers on the team. The Pipkins, well, that's way back. Joe and Jim, the pitch has popped up, foul and out of play. 3 balls, 2 strikes, Ray Townsend. Trying to get the leadoff man here. Young sophomore pitcher on the mound. Again, very talented, as all the Townsends were coming to the baseball program. 3-2 pitch. In for strike three. Good looking pitch by Ray Townsend for another strikeout for Wayne County. Third strikeout recorded by Wayne County pitching here in the scrimmage. 2 by Bryce, now 1 for Ray. Here's Caden Spivey, the shortstop. The pitch outside, ball one. 1-0. Nice night for baseball. It's supposed to be nice weather all this week. Don't forget the region basketball tournament tomorrow. 4 games on tap starting at 3 o'clock on Wednesday. The girls for Wayne County play South Effingham at 6:30, and the boys play Ware County at 8 o'clock. That's the games for Wayne County tomorrow, 6:30 and 8. Come on, support the Wayne County basketball team. Get a chance to win a region title on Friday night here at home. Pitch inside for ball three. 3-0 from Ray Townsend. Looking to see if there's any changes defensively, but it looks like it's the same lineup thus far. A 3-0 pitch, and it's up high, ball four. First walk given up by Wayne County pitching. Comes here in the third inning, a one-out walk to the number 8 hitter for Vidalia. Brings up number 20 left fielder, Bryce Davis, left fielder. Third inning action, game scheduled for 7 here at the Bowl. Wayne County scrimmage with Vidalia. Ray Townsend ready the pitch, and they lay down a bunt. Ray quickly off the mound, fields and throws to first for the out. Nice sacrifice bunt. Other number 9 hitter moves the runner over to second base, gives himself up, 1-3 on the putout. That brings up the top of the order, and Garrett Gillis, the center fielder.
Batting number 5, center fielder Garrett Gillis.
Gillis, a one-hopper to second baseman Griffin Boykin back in the first inning.
game moving right along. Nice pace here between Wayne County and Vidalia. Both coaches going to look at a lot of players, a lot of pitchers. Rays bluff throw to second base, runner back in time. Day in Brunswick, Georgia. We'll have it for you on the Big Dog 105.5. I think there's four games next week. Doubleheader Saturday, Monday. I think there's either a game Tuesday, or I just didn't bring the pocket schedule with me. But I'll have that for you on sports tomorrow. But we've got all the games for you. Home and away as we bring you Wayne County Baseball 2019. Ray Townsend stares in the stretch, the pitch. Round ball off of Ray Townsend's glove to Cooper Martin's glove. Cooper throws high into the dugout. The run's going to score for Vidalia. Runner hit to second base. And it's a throwing error at short. And Vidalia strikes first to make it a 1-0 ball game. Hard hit ball by Gillis. It ricocheted off Ray's glove. Went straight to Cooper. Had plenty of time, but just airmailed the throw. And the runner from second heads to third and comes home to score to make it a 1-0 ball game in favor of the Vidalia Indians. Brings up Dawson Ricks, the third baseman. For now, the pitcher for Vidalia Indian pitcher. Rays pitches in for a strike. Two down, runner at second. 1-0 Vidalia here in the scrimmage. Stretch the pitch. Inside, almost hit him. Ball one, 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs. Ray Townsend stares in. Stretching to 1-1. In for a strike, 1-2. One ball, two strikes, Landry Mead on the on-deck circle. Ray Townsend stares in. One ball, two strikes, two outs. The pitch, down low, ball two, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Ray Townsend ready, the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and that ends the inning. In the top of the third, Vidalia gets on the scoreboard. One run, no hits. One big error, one man left on base. We go to the bottom of the third. Score reads now, Vidalia Indians 1, Wayne County 0.
When a legal battle comes your way, you want the best team in that courthouse. Our Jackets take the field prepared and ready to go. And like the Jackets, we stay prepared for any legal challenge. Now, we might not answer the phone in the shower, and it might take more than one call, maybe even two, but we're ready to fight for you. If you or your loved one has been injured or you're facing any other legal battle, give us a call. Tracy Allen Brown, 912-427-2504 or www.uneedbrown.com.
Hurricanes Convenience Store and Cafe invites everyone to stop by before or after the game. It's a one-stop store with just about everything you need to get through the day. Whether it's a fill-up with gasoline or a snack or a delicious breakfast Monday through Friday at Hurricanes Cafe, yes, Hurricanes is that one-stop shop convenience store and is ready to serve you. Hurricanes is locally owned and operated by the Twilley family. Ron and the gang invite you to stop by. If you need to call, the number is 912-294-2276. It's Hurricanes, a hurricane you run to and not from. Hurricanes Convenience Store and Cafe, ready to serve you.
Damon's Restaurant is open 7 days a week and offers daily specials and has a wide variety of menu items from salads to wings to burgers and fries, and check out their famous turkey burger. Damon's is famous for their variety of sauces, mild, wild, insane, or inferno. And when it comes to party platters, Damon's can make your party special. Simply call on the order ahead of time by calling 588-WING, 588-9464. Damon's Famous Fingers and Wings continues to please its customers, and if you're looking for a great meal any day of the week, stop by and enjoy Damon's. You stop in or use the drive-thru at the location 336 West Cherry Street. That's Damon's Restaurant, a Wayne County favorite.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095. 427-2095.
We head to the bottom half of the third inning.
Jackets.
Top of the order for Wayne County.
Cooper Martin.
Cooper Martin, followed by Griffin Boykin, and then David Mosley. 1-2-3 hitters for Wayne County here in the bottom half of the third inning. Couple features this year. Again, they got the home run where Wayne Memorial Hospital will donate $100 to Fairhaven for every home run hit this year, or $50, I should say, for every home run hit. And we also got the call of the bullpen this year, again, sponsored by attorney Tracy Allen Brown. Cooper at the plate, strikeout victim back in the first inning. Bats here in the third against another new pitcher for Vidalia, Caden Spivey, number 8 pitching now. The 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss, strike one, 1-1. One ball, one strike, nobody on, nobody out. Bottom half of the third, Vidalia 1, Wayne County 0. The 1-1 pitch. Outside, ball 2-1. Line scores right now for the Indians, 1 run, no hits, no errors. Wayne, no runs, 2 hits, 1 error. The error allowed the run to score. The 2-1 pitch. Ball 3-1. Three balls, one strike. A 3-1 to Cooper. And it's down low, ball 4. Leadoff walk for Cooper Martin. Tying run on, and nobody out.
Second baseman, Griffin Boykin.
Here's Griffin Boykin. Strikeout victim back in the first as well. See how Coach McDonald wants to play it here, down by a run, third inning action. Number 2 hitter Griffin Boykin at the plate for Wayne County. Caden Spivey ready to stretch the pitch, and it's up high, ball 1. 1-0. First two pitchers right down the strike zone here. Third pitcher for Vidalia struggling here with his control. Caden Spivey. That's what these scrimmages are all about. Get people out there, get some experience, get some work here before the season kicks in. The 1-0, and that's low ball 2, 2-0. On deck, David Mosley, the DH, batting for Blake Wood, then Zach Thomas in the cleanup spot for Wayne County. Two balls, no strikes. The 2-0 pitch. And that's low ball 3, 3-0. Spivey all over the place, having trouble with the zone here in the third inning. Three balls, no strikes. Runner first, nobody out. The 3-0. And that's in for a strike, 3-1. Three balls, one strike. Cooper Martin at first base for Wayne County here in the bottom of the third represents the tie run. At the moment, we trail 1-0 in this scrimmage. A 3-1 pitch. Ball 4. Runners at first and second, nobody out. Back-to-back walks to start the third for Wayne County, and time called as the Vidalia Indian coach on his way to the mound. And that may be all for Spivey here. We're waiting to see if he wants to stick with him here. Discussion on the mound, and he's going to hang with him for the time being. Short discussion, I'm sure, was, kid, you got to throw strikes. You want to pitch, you got to throw strikes. If not, you got to have to find another position.
Headed in the 26th designated hitter, David Mosley.
David Mosley steps to the plate. 1-0 ball game, Wayne County trailing at the moment, but trading here in the bottom of the third with two free passes by Caden Spivey. David Mosley hit a base hit back in the first inning. Squares the bunt, misses, strike one. No balls, one strike. So Coach McDonald and Coach Munnis want to move the runners over, but David Mosley could not get the bunt down on that first pitch. So they're having a short discussion, see if they wave it off or keep it on here. Bottom of the third inning, 1-0 Vidalia. On deck, Zach Thomas for Wayne County, then Ty Anderson, Jacob Brewer, Jasper Stanfield, Bryce Miller, Hamp Perkins. David showing bunts, and bunts foul. No balls and two strikes. So we'll see if they take the bunt sign off with the two-strike count, which most coaches normally do. But not a bad number three hitter to be swinging away here on an 0-2 pitch. No balls, two strikes, nobody out, two runners on base, the stretch of the 0-2 pitch. And Spivey steps off and sends the runners back to first and second. No balls, two strikes, the stretch, the pitch, and that ball is hit to first, steps on the bag, throws down, and gets the runner. I guess not. I guess he didn't step on the bag. I thought he stepped on the bag and threw down, but apparently not. So it's runners at first and third. The first baseman quickly went to second base for the fielder's choice, and the lead runner at second. Cooper comes to third, so we got runners at the corners, first and third.
Hey, Zach Thomas. Third baseman, Zach Thomas.
Zach Bostock on a fielder's choice back in the first in the inning.
Zach, big bat right here, kid, big bat.
Big, tall, right-handed batter, Zach Thomas, getting the cleanup duties here in his first varsity start. Pitch down low, ball one, 1-0. Again, our former cleanup hitter in Canada didn't come out this year. Mr. James Marlin, cleanup hitter his sophomore year, cleanup hitter his junior year, senior year in Canada. The pitch, and for a strike, 1-1. He's one of our better pitchers too. Gant, Starlin, and Heatwood pretty much penciled him 1-2, but they're both unavailable at the moment. So Bryce is in that number one spot at the moment. Hopefully get Gant back sometime during the season. The 1-1 pitch, chopper to first, and fair ball. They're gonna tag the runner coming down. Cooper has to stay at third, and there's two down. Again, Cooper could not advance on that ball. Little chopper, 3 foot down the line on the first base side. First baseman charges it, fields it, and just tags Zach coming down the line.
Number nine, first baseman.
So we've got two on, two out. Both runners in scoring position now, second and third, but it takes a two-out hit by Ty Anderson, who walked back in the second inning. See if Ty can get Wayne County on the board here in this third inning. Stretching the pitch, and is on the corner for strike one. No balls, one strike. No balls, one strike, two outs. 1-0 ball game in favor of Vidalia here in the third. Wayne threatening, two on, both in scoring position. The 0-1 pitch, down low, bounces away from the catcher, and Cooper's gonna score. We're tied 1-1. So a wild pitch in the dirt, and Wayne ties it 1-1. Zach Thomas. Or Dave Mosley, I'm sorry, Dave Mosley down at third base now. With the go-ahead run, count 1-1 to Ty Anderson. Heads up play by Cooper. As soon as he saw that ball bounce away from the catcher, he was on his way to home plate. The 1-1 pitch, way up high, ball two, 2-1. Jacob Brewer, the catcher, on deck for Wayne County.
Two balls, one strike, two outs. Tie game, 1-1 in the third inning. The 2-1 pitch. Inside and low, ball 3-1. He's already walked two batters in the inning. Against five, he's struggling here for Vidalia in the third. Not a good inning for him. Two walks to lead off. A couple of fielder's choice. A wild pitch. 3-1 pitch to Ty Anderson. Ty pops it up foul out of play. The count runs full at 3-2. Three balls, two strikes. A runner at third for Wayne County, Dave Mosley.
Got a battle right here, got a battle.
Three balls, two strikes, the payoff pitch. Being air at third base. And Wayne has the 2-1 advantage as Dave Mosley comes home to score. And he's at first, or I'm sorry, Ty Anderson at first base.
And number 10, number 15, catcher Jacob Brewer.
And it brings up catcher Jacob Brewer. Moving to the on-deck circle, Jasper Stanfield. So Wayne back on top, 2-1. Two runs, two hits, one error by Vidalia. Vidalia still one run, no hits, one error by Wayne. Pitches down low, runner going to second base, throw down to second base, and safe at second base. Nice slide by Ty Anderson. That was a great throw by the catcher. The ball beat the runner there, but Ty Anderson able to slide in on the backside of the bag. Stolen base for Ty Anderson. Runner in scoring position. Two down, one ball, no strikes to Jacob Brewer. Jacob popped out to the pitcher back in the second inning. Time call, and Jacob steps out. Here's the stretch. And the pitch, ground ball, right side, second baseman in the grass, throws, got him. That ends the inning, but in the inning, Wayne comes back to take the lead on two free passes by the pitcher. It was two runs, no hits, one error, and one man left on base. We go to the fourth inning of the scrimmage. It's Wayne County 2 and Vidalia 1.
Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup is your full-service medical equipment provider for Southeast Georgia. We accept most insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, TRICARE, and Blue Cross Blue Shield. We offer 24-hour on-call service. Come see us for your respiratory needs, including oxygen and CPAP. Plus, we have the equipment to get you back on your feet, from beds to scooters to walkers and more. And we offer a full line of scrubs. Come see our friendly staff. Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup and Brunswick. Your quality of life is our business.
Does your car or truck need a paint job, body repair, or even a tow? Call the experts at Lassie's Body Shop, family owned and operated since 1978, where the courteous, knowledgeable, and professional staff will meet all your needs at Lassie's Body Shop, where everybody is somebody. Call us today. Let us take the stress away. We are located at 1526 Rainier Road, just past the Dollar Store. Give us a call at 385-6193. That's 385-6193. Lassie's Body Shop.
Wayne Memorial Hospital wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck as they pursue region and state championships. The hard work and dedication of our coaches and student athletes has been instrumental to your success. The staff at Wayne Memorial Hospital is also dedicated to providing and delivering the best possible health care to everyone who comes through our doors. We consider it an honor and a privilege to be entrusted with your health care needs. Caring for the community isn't just our motto, it's what we love to do. Wayne Memorial Hospital, the official health care provider of the Yellow Jackets.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Duncan Auto Service, 566 West Cherry Street, Jessup. Call 385-2153, 385-2153.
Fourth inning, another new pitcher for Wayne County.
Sean Steverson. Got a pitch here, a right-hander.
Where's the top of the fourth for the Indians, number 13, Landry Meade.
Lead, everything else stays the same. We keep looking to see if we're getting changed defensively, but I don't believe we do. Smiley will keep you posted if we do. He's got a better eye than I do. Fourth inning action. 3, 4, and 5 to face Sean Steverson, another right-hander for Wayne County. Sean, one of those juniors. There's a ball pop fouled out of play. Sean, one of the three, as we mentioned, three juniors on the squad. Jasper Stanfield, Sean Steverson, and J.C. Williams. Facing 3, 4, and 5 here in the top of the fourth in a 2-1 game. Wayne County with a one-run lead. Ball hit hard, but foul and out of play. Quickly, no balls and two strikes. The number three hitter, Landry Meade, number 13, started the game on the mound, still out there on the field here for Vidalia. The 0-2 pitch, up high, ball one, 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Sean Steverson stares in the 1-2 pitch. Call, strike three, right down the heart of the plate. Nice pitch by Sean Steverson. One up, one down. Brings up the cleanup hitter, Michael Blunt, the first baseman.
Number 21, Michael Blunt.
Just joining us is a scrimmage between Wayne and Vidalia. Wayne leads it 2-1. There's a line drive, base hit right field. First hit of the game for Vidalia. It comes for their cleanup hitter here in the top of the fourth inning. Saw the single to right. One on, one down for the number five hitter, Carson McClellan, the right fielder. Looking forward to another exciting year, Wayne County Yellow Jacket Baseball. And WIFO-FM has all the games for you, home and away this year on the Big Dog. All kicks off Monday night, 6 o'clock down in Brunswick. We'll start the pregame show again at 5:50 on Monday down at Brunswick High School's field. No longer Ed O'Miller. They built a school facility right on this campus when they built a new school there, so that's where they play now. It's a nice facility. Been there the last couple of years. Nice press box. And don't have to deal with the sand that's as bad as you did down at Ed O'Miller. 2-1 game here, top of the fourth. One on, one out. Sean Steverson ready to pitch. And that's outside, ball one. 1-0. Wayne 2, Vidalia 1. Top of the fourth. Game scheduled for 7 here this evening. Stretching the pitch. Down low. Looking forward to tomorrow night's basketball. Again, if Kayla Hobbs and the girls win tomorrow night, that'll be Kayla's 100th career win as a coach for Wayne County. So she'll hit a milestone again. What a great hire that was. Just a great girls basketball coach, good person. Really like watching how she handles her team, the way she coaches. Just, again, has that pedigree, pick hires, the daddy, catfish. Had a great basketball career as well. Again, just a good basketball family. But just Kayla's doing an excellent job as a girls varsity basketball coach. Coach Ray's having a great year as a better boys coach. Again, if you haven't seen the boys team, they're a lot of fun to watch. Got a deep bench, talented kids. Should have a chance to win both region titles this weekend on Friday. Pitches up high, ball four, and Vidalia has two runners on and one man out. And that brings up
number 18, Hughes Graham.
Hughes Graham, the catcher. So Vidalia has the tying run in scoring position at second base. A go-ahead runner at first base. Here for Sean Steverson, 2 on, 1 down. And the catcher, Hughes Graham, the number 6 hitter in the lineup, steps to the plate. He hit a line drive right to the first baseman, Ty Anderson, back in the second inning. Here's the stretch and the pitch. Swung on and fouled straight back. No balls, one strike. Boy, he took a rip of that one. Just missed fouls it straight back to the screen. No balls, one strike. Use Graham, the catcher. No balls, one strike. Sean Steverson setting ready the stretch, the pitch. In for a strike. No balls, two strikes. No balls, two strikes, one down, 2-1 game. Runners lead first and second. But a nice double play ball. Be nice to see one of those here in this scrimmage. The 2-1, or the 0-2, I'm sorry, 1-2 now. One ball, two strikes. On deck is Matt Moyer, the second baseman. By day of threatening here, they got two runners on, one down. Wayne leads it 2-1. Here in the fourth inning. Here's the stretch, the pitch, and check swing or did he swing? Yeah, they said he swung, so he's got to be out. Runners move up. They're saying they're a ball. They're not saying he swung. They're saying it's a ball in the dirt. So the runners get to advance to second and third. And the batter still at the plate. Two ball, two strikes. Wayne County thought he swung at the pitch. That's why he ran. So now comes Coach McDonald. Now they're going to appeal, and they're going to say, yeah, he did swing. So there is two outs. That brings up Matt Moyer. So the runners advance to second and third, but there is an out, another strikeout for Wayne County pitching. Sean Stevenson gets his second here in the fourth. And Matt Moyer, who struck out back in the third, bats here with two on, two out. Stretching the pitch. Down low in the dirt. Nice block by Jacob Brewer. Good job of saving a run there. And he did that on the JV level all last year. It's a good-looking defensive catcher, Jacob Brewer. Good-looking athlete, another talented kid in the program. Doing a good job behind the plate. One ball, no strikes. The pitch in for a strike, 1-1. Good pitch by Sean Steverson there. One ball, one strike. Two outs, need a key out here. One ball, one strike pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Good fastball by Steverson. One ball, two strikes. Chance to get out of it without any damage and keep a one-run lead headed to the bottom of this fourth inning. See if Sean Steverson can strike out the side here in his fourth inning of work, or his first inning work here in the fourth. The 1-2 pitch. Up high, ball two, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Two runners on base. Deuces wild here in the fourth for the Vidalia Indians. Sean Steverson looking for out number three, the 2-2 pitch. Up high, ball three, full count. 3-2, if he loses them, he will load them up for Spivey. Full count, big pitch here by Sean Steverson. Three ball, two strike, two outs, two runners on base, both in scoring position. The payoff pitch on the way, and he lost in ball four. The bases are loaded. So a second walk to go with two strikeouts and a base hit. The bases are juiced. Three ducks on the pond for Carson Spivey. New batter here, number 17, Bryce Whited. So a pinch hitter, Whited comes to the plate, the pitch, and that's up high, ball one. No place to put him. A walk's a tie game. Three ducks on the pond for the first time in the year 2019. Vidalia Indians threatening here. The 1-0 pitch. Fly ball, right field. Right fielder coming in. Can he get there? He does. Nice catch in right field by Hamp Perkins to end the inning.
In the inning, the Vidalia Indians come up empty. No runs, one hit, no errors. They strand three. We head to the bottom of the fourth. It remains Wayne 2, Vidalia 1.
At Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors. Custom landscape design, including sod installation, shrubs and trees, bedding plants, unique hardscapes, seating areas, fire pits, archway entrances, and pavers. Design Landscaping can also do sprinkler systems, fencing, and more. Call Ryan Madry at Design Landscaping, 678-347-6136, 678-347-6136. On Facebook, Design Landscaping, Instagram, Design_Landscaping. Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors.
Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop is proud to be sponsoring Wayne County Yellow Jacket Baseball and wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck this baseball season. Sheffield's has all your Under Armour winter and cold gear as they are the new Under Armour provider in this area. Sheffield's has all you need to outfit your team, bats, balls, caps, jackets, you name it, they've got it. Sheffield's is located 1516 West Orange Street and has everything you need when it comes to sporting goods. Stop by or give them a call today. The number is 427-2982. Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop wishing the Yellow Jackets the best of luck all season. Mobile Concrete in Jessup wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck in today's game and wants everyone to know that no job is too big or small for Mobile Concrete. Mobile Concrete has locations in Jessup, Baxley, Brunswick, Glenville, Hinesville, Darien, and Ahoney, Georgia. Located at 1705 Highway 341 South in Jessup, just past Neesmith Chevrolet on the left. Seven plant locations with 25 mixtures. Give Mobile Concrete a call today at 427-2330. Mobile Concrete says go Wayne County.
Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Southeast Georgia Garage Door. Call 266-6567, 266-6567, Southeast Georgia Garage Door.
Welcome back. New pitcher on for Vidalia. Number 17, Bryce Whited, who batted in the inning. And he'll face Jasper Stanfield here to lead off things for Wayne County, followed by Bryce Miller and Ham Perkins. 7-8-9 for Wayne in the bottom of the fourth in a 2-1 ball game. 2-1, two runs, two hits, one error for Wayne, one run, one hit, one error for Vidalia. And a hit batter. Jasper gets plunked in the back and he heads to first base, hit by a pitch to start the fourth inning.
Batting number 19, Bryce Miller.
Brings up Bryce Miller, who bunted his way on for a base hit back in the second inning. A good start to the fourth inning. Runner on, nobody out. Ham Perkins on deck. Just made a nice sliding catch in right field to end the inning. Stretching the pitch. Down low, ball one. 1-0. One ball, no strikes, one out. Wayne County and Vidalia in a scrimmage here at Howard Bow on a nice night for baseball. Bryce Miller squaring the bunt again and does bunt and puts it right out in front of the plate. And now they're saying foul ball. Looked like a good bunt. Oh, is it a foul ball? Oh, hit his foot, okay. That's why it's a foul ball, that makes sense. One ball, one strike. Nobody out, runner at first base. The right-hander delivers and the pitch, and it's in for a strike. Throw down to second base and a stolen base. Ball ricochets into right field, and Jasper Stanfield up quickly comes to third. Good hustle by Jasper. And Wayne County with a runner at third base, nobody out. Now they'll take this bunt sign off Bryce Miller in a 1-2 count. Let him swing away here and see if he can drive in Jasper Stanfield down at third base. 2-1 game. Yellow Jackets lead it over Vidalia here in the scrimmage at Howard Bow Warren. One ball, two strike count. the stretch, the pitch, and Bryce swings, and it's one hopper short. Shortstop coming home, and not in time. Good hustle by Jasper Stanfield. Bryce drives it home, and Wayne County ups the lead to 3-1. So Wayne County, 3, Vidalia, 1.
Hey, number 18, right here, Ham Perkins.
Brings up Ham Perkins, right fielder for Wayne County, another one of the seniors on the squad. Stretching the pitch to Ham. Ground ball, third base makes a nice play. Can he get the out at first? He does. A one hopper over to first base and got a nice play by number 11 at third base, Dawson Ricks. That was a nice play. Took away extra bases from Ham Perkins and still got him out of first base. Ham's got some good speed down the line. And Ricks got up quickly and threw a one hopper the first base for the out. Nice defensive play. And Ham's got some speed, so that was a great defensive play at third. Here's Cooper. Bryce Miller down at second base on the hard hit ball by Ham Perkins. Pitches up high, ball one, 1-0. Cooper on the night, walked and scored, struck out back in the first inning. 0-for-1 officially in the book. Chance to drive in a run here. Here's the stretch and the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss, strike one, 1-1. One ball, one strike, one down. Bottom of the fourth, Wayne 3, Vidalia 1. Senior Cooper Martin at the plate for Wayne County at the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, runner coming to third, and he is out at third base. Bryce Miller thrown out at third by the catcher for out number 2, and the bases are empty. Try the arm of Dawson Ricks, and Ricks, I'm sorry, try the arm of Hugh Graham. Dawson Ricks made the tag at third. 2 down in the inning. Count 1-2 to Cooper Martin. 1-2, Cooper asks for time and gets it from the home plate umpire and steps out. Griffin Boykin on deck for Wayne County, Wayne County second baseman. 1-2, 2 outs, 3-1 game in favor of Wayne County. The 1-2 pitch, ground ball foul past third, count remains 1-2. Line scores at this time, 3 runs, 3 hits now for Wayne, 1 error for the Yellow Jackets, 1 run, still just 1 hit for Vidalia. They've committed 2 errors in the ball game. We're in the bottom of inning number 4, Wayne County 3, Vidalia 1. Cooper Martin, senior shortstop at the plate, nobody on base, 1-2 count to him, a 1-2 pitch. Fly ball, left field, pretty well hit, left fielder over, he's not going to get there. Cooper's got extra bases. Cooper flying to second, and he's thinking about 3, but they're going to hold him at second base with a stand-up double. Cooper laces a double down the left field corner. Left fielder tried to make a dive and catch, could not get there. And Cooper is at second base.
Batting number 10, second baseman, Griffin Boykin.
Here's Griffin Boykin, struck out in the first and walked in the third. Griffin Boykin at the plate. 3-1 score in favor of Wayne. Chance for a run here. Griffin can pick up a base hit. Struck out and walked. Cooper did the same, and then Cooper laced a double. We'll see if Griffin can get his first hit. Breaking pitch in for a strike. No balls, 1 strike. Senior year for Griffin Boykin. Again, they had the homecoming festivities. He was crowned the king. The king and his court were crowned Saturday night at the Benny Radler Arena. Well, if he still has, I'm sure he has the crown. I just wonder where the crown's at. The pitch, fly ball right field. That's going to be trouble. That's in for a hit. Cooper's going to score, and Wayne makes it a 4-1 ball game. Griffin gets one down the right field corner for a base hit, RBI.
And Wayne County leads it by a score of 4-1 here in the fourth inning. It's interesting. Super Bowl week, Kyler Murray was asked where he keeps his Heisman trophy. He says he's got a table right by his bed, and when he wakes up every morning, it's right there.
And number 26, this is David Moses.
He says that's how he starts his day. He wakes up and says, "That I'm a Heisman trophy winner right there. There's my Heisman." The pitch the day Mosley swung on and fouled out of play. No balls, one strike. 2-9 in the inning. We're in the fourth, 4-1 ball game. It was fun Super Bowl week up in Atlanta. Got to meet a lot of people. I think the highlight was talking to Roger Staubach. Roger the Dodger from Naval Academy. Great years with the Cowboys. Talking about how Tom Landry was just a guy who brought so much to football. The Cowboys were the first one to implement the shotgun. Now everybody's doing the shotgun. But it was something brand new when Tom Landry implemented with the Roger Staubach. And Staubach said he did it because Staubach could run as well as throw. So they just used his ability in that shotgun. And now everybody uses the shotgun. Two down, a runner at first base. Dave Mosley to play the stretch in the 0-2 pitch. Up high, ball one. 1-2. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Zach Thomas on deck. Dave Mosley at the plate. One ball, two strikes, two outs. The 1-2 pitch on the way. Popped up, foul territory, first baseman over, makes the catch. And that ends the fourth inning for Wayne County, but a productive one for the Yellow Jackets. Wayne puts two runs on the board on three hits. One, an extra base hit by Cooper Martin, a double. No errors, one man left on base. We played four, score each, Wayne 4, Vidalia 1.
Every team knows a two-run double is big. That's why State Farm agent Robin Eubanks and her team are here to help you score by combining your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and money. So go for the win and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way we're here to help life go right. Call State Farm agent Robin Eubanks at 427-6008. 427-6008. Go Jackets!
Jim Boykin of Boykin Steel and Crane wish the Yellow Jackets the best of luck this season, and Boykin Steel and Crane's legacy will make your foundation stronger as they specialize in steel fabrication, industrial maintenance, steel erection, crane rentals, and concrete. Boykin Steel and Crane in operation in Justin and Wayne County since 1972. Jim Boykin has taken over the family business and continues to do what's best for his community. Boykin Steel and Crane, located on the Savannah Highway in Jessup. The number to call is 427-7751. Boykin Steel and Crane, again, wishing the Yellow Jackets the best of luck.
Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue, now open 823 North 1st Street, 6 a.m. until 9 p.m. 6 days a week. They offer dine-in and drive-thru for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. In addition, catering, delivery, and fundraisers. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue. Stop by or call 912-385-2657, 385-2657 for fast pickup service. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue supports Wayne County Baseball. Go Jackets! Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095, 427-2095.
Head to the top of the fifth inning. New pitcher for Wayne County, Blake Wood, on the mound now for Wayne County.
Top of the fifth, for the Indians. Number 20, Bryce Davis.
Blake Wood started out in center field, but now he's on the mound, a lefty for Wayne County. Blake's first pitch. And it's in for a strike. No balls, one strike. Blake Wood, one of the sophomores for Wayne County. And the sophomore group's got some pitchers. Blake Wood, Ray Townsend, John Eston Shaver. Pitches in for strike two. No balls and two strikes. 9-1-2 to face Blake Wood here. Fourth pitcher for Wayne County in the ballgame. Blake's 0-2 pitch. Just missed 1-2. One ball, two strikes. So as we mentioned before the game, that Coach McDonald would use this scrimmage to get as many arms out there as he possibly can. And we're only in the fifth inning. This is the fourth pitcher Wayne County seen. Bryce went two. Seen Ray Townsend for an inning, Sean Steverson for an inning, now Blake Wood. Sure, there's more to come here as we head down the final couple innings of this scrimmage. Glad you're with us on the Big Dog 105.5. Reminder, we got all 30 games for you on the schedule, starting Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. Blake Wood ready, the wind, the 2-2 pitch. And it's outside, ball three, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, leadoff batter Garrett Gillis on deck for Vidalia. Payoff pitch, swing and a miss, he struck him out. Good job by Blake Wood, comes back and gets the payoff batter, payoff pitch for a strike. And there's one down. Seven strikeouts now by Wayne County pitching in this scrimmage. Coach Mullis and Barry Brown, and the pitching coach has got to be happy to see this. Again, just a good outing. Everybody throwing strikes, getting outs. That's what it's all about. No balls, one strike. I think Blake Wood's going to have a big year on that mound for Wayne County. What I saw Fun Day looked awfully. I mean, this kid's really growing from last year to this year. It's amazing how many you see them when they leave school and then they come back. And over the summer, they just, I don't know, it must be something good in the water. But this kid's really developed, grew up several inches, and just looks real good on that mound as a lefty. The 1-1. Down low, ball 2-2-1. I know he works hard too. A lot of these kids, I'll tell you, it's amazing. Not only do they put on hours during practice, but then when they leave practice, they put additional time in and go to different places, different hitting facilities, different places where they pitch. I know they keep the facility here available to them, but they spend a lot of hours developing their craft. I know this kid's put a lot of time and effort into it. Three balls, one strike, one out. Leadoff batter for Vidalia facing Blake Wood. The lefty's 3-1 pitch, and he lost in ball four. So after the leadoff strikeout, a walk here. Runner on, one down, and brings up Dawson Ricks.
Number 11, Dawson Ricks.
It's the fourth walk given up by Wayne County pitching. Ray Townsend walked a batter in the third. Steverson walked a couple in the fourth. This ball gets away from the catcher, and a runner heads down to second base. It's one ball, no strikes. Again, good action here at Howard Bogue. Been a nice scrimmage thus far. 4-1 game. Wayne County leads it. Vidalia batting here in the fifth with a runner at second base, one down. Time called as Jacob Brewer wants to go out and talk with Blake Wood. Again, if you missed the varsity roster, we'll run it down again. These kids on the varsity, some will play JV varsity, but it's Sean Steverson, Blake Wood, Brennan Lee, Blake Brockington, Trey Pierce, Ty Anderson, Griffin Boykin, Luke Boykin, J.C. Williams, Cooper Martin, Miles Starling, Zach Thomas, Hamp Perkins, Bryce Miller, Ray Townsend, Brad Irati, Tyler Dennison, Gant Starling, Jasper Stanfield, Jacob Brewer, and David Mosley. Again, that's your varsity roster for the year 2019 for Wayne County Baseball. Again, head coach Justin McDonald, assistant coaches Jordan Mullis, Barrett Browning, Mike Roberts, Colt Brockington, Buddy Starling, and the statistician this year is Adriana Martin. The 1-1 pitch from Blake Wood. Fly ball, right center field. Who wants it? Ham Perkins, right fielder, says he's got it. He does. And there's two down in the inning. Two down in the fifth. And that brings up number 13, Landry Meade, the number three hitter for Vidalia.
And number 13, Landry Meade.
And a reminder, region basketball tomorrow. Don't miss it. Girls play at 6:30, boys play at 8. Girls play South Effingham, boys play Ware County. If they win, they play for the region title on Friday night at the Benny Radcliffe Arena. Chance for a region title, chance for number one seed into the state bracket. Get to host some state events. That'll be fun. Been a while. Smiley asked the question that I did not have the answer. Maybe you got the answer. When was the last time the boys and girls team both won a region title together? Got any idea? It's been a while. I know that. I thought they did years ago when Benny and Barbara were coaching together, but I'm not positive. I said, I know it's been a long time, but got a chance to do it this weekend here in Wayne County. Yeah, the New Hampstead boys game, you know, New Hampstead and Wayne. Right. Yeah, it was a three-way tie, flip of coin, so those games are up in here as well. So. Home court could be big, though. Come on out and support the Yellow Jackets. Get that crowd, get that student body rocking. Maybe they get the pep band. The pep band's been there a couple times. That's been fun. So, looking for a big crowd Wednesday and Friday at the Benny Radcliff Arena. Wish Coach Hobbs and Coach Ray the best of luck this week. Be there tomorrow and Friday. Should be fun. Lakewood with a runner second, two down, two balls, one strike, two down. 4-1 game here. Wayne County leading the scrimmage over Vidalia. Lakewood, Wayne County's fourth pitcher on the mound here, getting an inning of work. Ray Townsend looks sharp. Steverson did a good job. Now Blake Wood, Bryce Miller got the first two innings, three up, three down on both innings. Throw to second base, and Blake throws it in the center field. Runner coming to third, center fielder back to throw. To throw, safe at third base. Now he's off the bag, and he's tagged out. Couldn't stay on the bag. He didn't slide, and that cost him. And the inning comes to a close. In the inning, no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We hit the bottom of the fifth. It remains Wayne County 4 and Vidalia 1.
Finding the right house starts with REMAX.com, featuring millions of properties just waiting to be called home. With all types of listings, we'll recommend what's right for you. That's the sign of a REMAX agent. Visit REMAX.com to find your home and agent now. Each office independently owned and operated.
Hey, this is April Banks with REMAX Elite. If you're in the market to buy or sell a home, don't do it alone. Give me a call at 912-424-0687. I would like to wish the Wayne County High School team best of luck this season. Go Jackets!
When you become a customer at Prime South Bank, you become part of a team that has your back and is with you every step of the way in achieving your financial goals. Our doors opened in 1891. 125 years later, we are still going strong. Prime South is constantly bringing innovative and convenient banking solutions to our growing communities. And our customers, well, they are the real MVPs. In the bank or on the field, Prime South's game face is always on for you. Prime South Bank, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Interstate Credit Union has all the ingredients you need of a financial institution, and we have 5 branch locations to serve you. You get the services you need, and your money stays here in the community. You can relax because you're doing business with people you know and people who know you. Membership is open to 10 counties. It's easy to join, so call, click, or stop by one of our 5 branch locations and become a member today. Member NCUA.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Duncan Auto Service, 566 West Cherry Street, Jessup. Call 385-2153. 385-2153.
Hit to the bottom of the fifth inning. Zach Thomas leads off of Wayne County.
Bottom fifth for the Yellow Jackets, number 17, Zach Thomas.
Looks like we got a different hitter on deck for Ty Anderson. We'll see who that is when he comes up. I'm sure we're going to see some other players step up to the plate here in these final 3 frames for Wayne County, but Zach Thomas currently 0 for 2 on the day. Here's the wind, the pitch to Zach, and it's inside, ball 1-0. Zach Thomas, third baseman, getting the cleanup duties here in game 1. We're in the scrimmage, the pitch, up high, ball 2-0. 2 balls, no strikes to Zach Thomas. Wayne County leads the scrimmage 4-1 here in the bottom of inning number 5. The pitch, and that's in for ball 3-0. On the mound now for Vidalia. Number 17, still whited, so he's still out there. The 3-0 pitch. That's in for a strike, 3-1. 3 balls, 1 strike. The 3-1 pitch. Popped up foul and out of play. Full count, 3-2.
3-2 to Zach Thomas. Payoff pitch to Zach. And it's up high, ball four, leadoff walk to start the bottom of the fifth for Wayne County. And come to the plate, Ray Townsend going to get back.
Number 28, Ray Townsend.
And a free substitution in this scrimmage as well. Again, doesn't matter where they play it or whatever, so they can flip them in anywhere they want. So Ray Townsend going to bat here for Ty Anderson, right-handed batter. Swing and a miss, strike one. No balls, one strike. Swung hard that looked like a four Townsend swing. I almost had a deja vu. Same number, same swing. Here's the stretch. Throw to first, runner back in time. Forward up at Mercer. So got to see him not long ago. Asked him how things are going. Said he's going. Up there playing for the Mercer Bears. Here's the stretch in the 0-1 to Ray Townsend. And it's down low, ball one, 1-1. One ball, one strike, nobody out. Bottom of the fifth inning, Wayne County leading Vidalia 4-1 here in the scrimmage at Howard Bo Warren Field. Stretch in the 1-1 pitch. Down low, ball two, 2-1. 2 balls, 1 strike. Ray Townsend at the plate for Wayne County. 2-1, in for a strike, 2-2. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Runner first base, nobody out. Bottom of inning number 5, Wayne and Vidalia in the scrimmage here at Howard Bow. Here's the stretch in the 2-2. Good looking breaking pitch. Ray Townsend got caught looking, and there's one down here in the fifth inning. Nice breaking pitch in for strike three. Brings up
number 15, Jacob Brewer.
Jacob Brewer, the catcher. Jacob 0-2, popped out and grounded out. Doing a good job behind the plate here in this scrimmage. Very impressed. There's a ground ball to third, chance for two. Down to second, they throw it by the second base. All hands safe, a throwing error at third. And that was a routine double play ball, but he threw it wide of the bag at second base, so all hands safe. Runners at first and second, one down. And
batting number two, Sean Steverson.
Sean Steverson going to get the bat here. Two runners on, one man down here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Wayne leading it 4-1, chance to increase the lead. I think we got a runner at first base for Jacob Brewer. Who's that running at first base? We know. We'll try to get that number. Pitch it down low. Runners are moving up. Looks like number 5. That's Brendan Lee.
Brendan Lee is the currency runner.
So Brendan Lee in running here, and now at second base. Runners at second and third. That ball got by the catcher. 1-0 pitch to Steverson. Pitch down low. And it's ball two. 2-0. 2 balls, no strikes. Chance to increase the lead here in the fifth, leading it 4-1. 4 runs, 6 hits thus far for Wayne. Just 1 hit for Vidalia. 1 run. Swing and a miss, strike one, 2-1 to Steverson. Two balls, one strike, 1 out. The 2-1 pitch, down low, ball 3, 3-1.
Three balls, one strike, one out. 4-1 ball game in favor of Wayne County here in a scrimmage with Vidalia. A 3-1 pitch, swing and a missed strike two, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, one down. Payoff pitch. Popped up foul, but out of play. And the count remains full to Sean Steverson at 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Stretching the 3-2 pitch. Ground ball up the middle. And the shortstop behind the bag throws, got him at first base. But a run comes in to make it a 5-1 ball game. Two outs in the inning. Nice play behind the bag by the shortstop. Gets that runner at first base.
Bryce Miller.
Here's Bryce Miller. Bryce been on base twice with two hits. Both infield variety. On a bunt and on an infield hit. Here's the stretch in the pitch. Grounded foul. No balls, one strike. No balls, one strike, two outs. 5-1 Wayne County. Game scheduled for 7 here this evening at Howard Bell Warren. Stay tuned for the Country Financial post-game show. We'll hear from Coach McDonald, get his thoughts on the game. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike two, 0-2. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Just missed 1-2. Good looking pitch. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Little ground ball, slow roller to third. Third baseman's not going to be able to handle it. Another infield hit for Bryce Miller. And a run in for Wayne County to make it a 6-1 ball game. So Bryce Miller 3-for-3 here in this ball game.
Number 18, Hamp Perkins.
Here's Hamp Perkins, 0-for-2, bounced out twice, twice to third. Third baseman and assisted ground ball, touched the bag with the runners at first and second in the second inning and grounded out to third in the fourth inning. Bats here with a runner first, two down, leadoff batter Cooper Martin on deck. The pitch and is down low, ball one, 1-0. One ball, no strikes, two outs.
Do a job right here, kid, do a job!
Stretching the pitch. And there's a line drive base hit center field. And Perkins with the base hit. Runners at first and second for Cooper Martin.
Batting number 14, Cooper Martin.
Cooper had a double and a run scored back in the fourth, walked and scored in the third, struck out in the first inning. Officially 1-for-2 on the day. Griffin Boykin, second baseman on deck. 6-1 game in favor of Wayne County. the pitch, swing and a miss. Strike one. Pitch is outside. Ball one, 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs. The 1-1 pitch. Swung on and foul out of play, 1-2 to Cooper. One ball, two strikes, two outs. 6-1 Yellow Jackets over Vidalia here at Howard Bow. And time call. That stays 1-2.
Got a batter right here, kid. Got a batter.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. A 1-2 pitch. Up high, ball two, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. 6-1 Wayne County over Vidalia here in the bottom of inning number 5. The 2-2 pitch, up high, ball three, 3-2. Walk would load them up for Griffin Boykin. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. The payoff pitch outside, ball four, and the bases are loaded for Griffin Boykin. So Wayne County for the first time has three ducks on a pond. Bases juiced, and here comes the coach for Vidalia. We may have one of those called to the bullpen. Called to the bullpen, sponsored by Tracy Allen Brown this year. So we'll see what the coach wants to do. Looks like he's asking for the ball, and it will be a call to the bullpen. We'll take a break. Score reads Wayne 6, Vidalia 1. Called to the bullpen, sponsored by attorney Tracy Allen Brown.
When a legal battle comes your way, you want the best team in that courthouse. Our Jackets take the field prepared and ready to go. And like the Jackets, we stay prepared for any legal challenge. Now, we might not answer the phone in the shower, and it might take more than one call, maybe even two. But we're ready to fight for you. If you or your loved one has been injured or you're facing any other legal battle, give us a call. Tracy Allen Brown, 912-427-2504. Or www.uneedbrown.com.
For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Southeast Georgia Garage Door. Call 266-6567. 266-6567. Southeast Georgia Garage Door.
New pitcher in for Vidalia as they go to the bullpen. Another right-hander for Vidalia. Going to face Griffin Boykin. Bases loaded.
Number 10,
Griffin Boykin.
So a new pitcher in for Vidalia. Trying to get that number. What's the new pitcher? Bryce Morley, 16. Morley, the new pitcher. The pitch to Griffin. And it's outside, ball one. 1-0. Chance to bust it wide open here in the fifth. It's a 6-1 game. Three ducks on a pond. Griffin Boykin at the plate had a base hit to right field his last time up. Pitch up high, ball two. 2-0. No place to put Griffin. Two balls, no strikes, two outs. The 2-0 pitch. In for a strike, 2-1. Two balls, one strike, the senior Griffin Boykin. Runners lead first and second. The 2-1 pitch. Up high, ball three, 3-1. Three balls, one strike, two outs. A walk is a run here in the bottom of the fifth for Wayne County. The 3-1 pitch. Call strike two, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. 6-1 Wayne County, Griffin Boykin at the plate. The 3-2 pitch, and he lost in ball four. A run is in. Another run coming home, throw home, and he's going to be out at home plate. So Hamp Perkins gets thrown out, coming around the bag. Coach McDonald just looking like, where are you going? Didn't give you the green light, but that's going to end the inning. In the inning, Wayne County picks up 1, 2, 3, 4 runs. Three runs. Couple hits, couple errors, couple men left on base. We play five. It reads now Wayne County 7, Vidalia 1.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Litowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Top Notch Lawn Care is here to serve your lawn and land needs. We offer everything from yearly contracts to one-time cleanups. Has your yard gotten out of hand? Let Top Notch Lawn Care give your property the attention it deserves. Call 912-271-3368.
For all your lawn care needs, call my daddy, Joey Scarborough, at 912-271-3368.
Heating and Air Co. for all your heating and air needs. We install the best and service the rest. 912-427-COOL, your hometown American Standard dealer.
Hey, Robbie, why American Standard?
Well, Jonathan, for the last 8 years in a row, American Standard Heating and Air Equipment has been number one in Consumer Reports as the most reliable system made, which makes it the best. That's why.
Makes sense to me, Robbie. How do I schedule my free replacement estimate?
Just call 912-427-COOL. Georgia license number CR110318.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095, 427-2095.
It's a sixth inning. New pitcher on the mound for Wayne County, Jasper Stanfield. Going to get the sixth here for Wayne County. Junior right-hander for the Wayne County Yellow Jackets. Wine and first pitch. Popped up foul and out of play. No balls, one strike. Facing the 3, 4, and 5 hitters this inning for Vidalia. Number 13 to plate, Landry Mead, followed by Michael Blunt and Carson McClellan. Jasper ready to wind the pitch. And it's inside. Ball one. 1-1.
a nice night for baseball here. Wayne County leads it 7-1. One ball, one strike from Jasper Stanfield. Jasper sitting ready. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. Strike two. 1-2. Blake Wood now in left field for Wayne County. Trying to see if there's any of the changes. Still Thomas at third. Cooper at short. Griffin still at second. There's a little topper down the third base line. They're going to let it roll foul. Smart play by Wayne County. Ray Townsend down there now at first base for Wayne County, number 20. Still Brewer behind the plate. Still Perkins in the right. And Bryson center. So, again, Blake Wood really the only defensive change right now for Wayne County out there in the field. So one ball, two strike count. Jasper Stanfield getting his inning of work here in the sixth. One ball, two strike count. The 1-2 pitch on the way. Grounded foul. It remains 1-2. And Wayne County's got a lot of arms, that's for sure. Just no matter who steps up and who fills those roles. Again, it's normally a 1-2-3, then some bullpen people, but just a lot of arms to choose from. It'll be interesting to see how the season goes and how it all shapes up. Again, Gant should be back sometime during the season, which will be a big boost. Here's the wind and the 1-2 pitch. Ground ball deep in the hole, back in it by Cooper. Long throw. Did he get him? We have no sign by the umpire, so I guess he's safe. So it's an infield hit. Don't they get a safe sign or not sign? I got a no sign by the umpire. He just started running towards second. So a leadoff single. Here's Michael Blunt. 1-for-2, singled and ground out to second base. 7-1 game, top of the sixth. Scrimmage here tonight between Wayne and Vidalia. Throw to first base and the runner's back in time. So Ray Townsend at first base, Blake Wood in left. Those are your defensive changes here in the sixth for Wayne County. Jasper Stanfield and a bonk called on Wayne County's Jasper Stanfield. So runner heads to second base. A 7-1 game. Indians have been held to two hits in the scrimmage thus far. Jasper ready to stretch. And the pitch swung on and fouled straight back. No balls, one strike. No balls, one strike. Nobody out. We're in the top of the sixth inning of a scrimmage scheduled for seven innings here at Howard Bell Warren. Again, stay tuned for the Country Financial postgame show. We'll hear from Coach McDonald after the ball game. Maybe some players. Here's the stretch and the pitch. And it's line foul past first base. And the count 0-2 to the batter. No balls, two strikes. Runner at second base. Nobody out. We're in the top of inning number six. Wayne 7, Vidalia 1. The pitch. Little chopper to short. Cooper fields it, throws, and got him. And there's one down in the inning.
Batting number 15, Carson McClellan.
Runner at third for Vidalia. And Carson McClellan bats the number 5 hitter. He struck out and walked his 2 trips to the plate here in the scrimmage. So see if Jasper can strand that runner at third base. Infield hit, bonk to second, and goes to third on a ground ball. There's a check swing, and he says he went after it, so it's no balls, one strike. Can it check the swing? Umpire says he swung, so there's no ball with one strike count to the batter.
7-1 Wayne County leading here over Vidalia. Yeah, we're glad you're with us here on the Big Dog 105.5 on the World Wide Web. 30 games coming your way here this season. The pitch. In for a strike. No balls, two strikes. No balls, two strikes, one out. Jasper Stanfield ready to wind the pitch. Little pop up, second baseman, shortstop. Cooper comes over and makes the catch for out number two. And there's two down in the sixth for Vidalia. Chance to strand that runner at third base. So that was a good out there for Wayne County. Jasper gets to pop up the infield.
Number six, Riley Powers.
And Powers steps to the plate. Riley Powers. Two down in the sixth. Wayne leads it 7-1. Jasper Stanfield ready to pitch. Swing and a miss, strike one. No balls, one strike. No balls, one strike, two outs. The 0-1 pitch. Up high, ball one. 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs. 7-1 game. Jasper ready, the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and foul back, 1-2. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Top of the sixth inning. Wayne 7, Vidalia 1. Jasper ready. The wind and the 1-2 pitch. Little check swing, little pop up. Griffin Boykin out of it. Outfield grass makes the catch. Inning comes to a close for Vidalia. No runs, one hit, no errors, a runner left on base. We head to the bottom of the sixth in the scrimmage here at the Howard Bow. It's Wayne 7, Vidalia 1.
Hurricanes Convenience Store and Cafe invites everyone to stop by before or after the game. It's a one-stop store with just about everything you need to get through the day. Whether it's a fill-up of gasoline or a snack or a delicious breakfast Monday through Friday at Hurricanes Cafe, yes, Hurricanes is that one-stop shop convenience store and is ready to serve you. Hurricanes is locally owned and operated by the Twilley family. Ron and the gang invite you to stop by. If you need to call, the number is 912-294-2276. It's Hurricanes, a hurricane you run to and not from. Hurricanes Convenience Store and Cafe, ready to serve you.
Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup is your full-service medical equipment provider for Southeast Georgia. We accept most insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, TRICARE, and Blue Cross Blue Shield. We offer 24-hour on-call service. Come see us for your respiratory needs, including oxygen and CPAP. Plus, we have the equipment to get you back on your feet, from beds to scooters to walkers and more. And we offer a full line of scrubs. Come see our friendly staff. Jones Medical Equipment in Jessup and Brunswick. Your quality of life is our business.
Does your car or truck need a paint job, body repair, or even a tow? Call the experts at Lassie's Body Shop, family owned and operated since 1978, where the courteous, knowledgeable, and professional staff will meet all your needs at Lassie's Body Shop, where everybody is somebody. Call us today. Let us take the stress away. We are located at 1526 Rainier Road, just past the dollar store. Give us a call at 385-6193. That's 385-6193. Lassie's Body Shop.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Duncan Auto Service, 566 West Cherry Street, Jessup. Call 385-2153. 385-2153.
Bottom of the sixth, Blake Wood going to lead off for Wayne County. Luke Boykin on deck with a bat. And we'll see who bats after that here in the bottom of the sixth. Wayne's last at bat here, leading it 7-1. Game scheduled for 7. Pitches up high, ball 1, 1-0. Wayne County Vidalia scrimmage in first game Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. We'll have it for you here on the Big Dog 105.5, 550 pregame show. First pitch, 6 p.m. Pitches down low. Ball 2, 2-0 to Blake Wood. Pitches low, ball 3 to Blake Wood.
Three balls, no strikes. The 3-0 pitch. In for a strike, 3-1. Three balls, one strike. Nobody on, nobody out. The 3-1 pitch. Popped up foul and out of play. Count runs four to Blake Wood. Three balls, two strikes. And a reminder, got region basketball action tomorrow at the Benny Radcliffe Arena. Girls at 6:30, boys at 8. If they win or lose, they're playing Friday. But if they win, they play for the region title on Friday at the gym. The payoff pitch to Blake. And is up high, ball four. Got the National Signing Day ceremony tomorrow at the high school auditorium. That gets underway at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
And number 11, Luke Boykin
comes to the plate for Wayne County. Luke steps to the plate with a runner on. Nobody out here in the bottom of the sixth. Stretching the pitch. And it's in for a strike. Luke Boykin.
Good job right here, Wong!
In the freshman class. So Luke, one of the freshmen here on the varsity level. Two ball, no strike count to him. Stretching the pitch, ball three, 3-0. One and two. It flipped on me. One ball, two strikes, Luke Boykin at the plate. The pitch, down low, ball two, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes against State of the Union address tonight by the president. Gets underway about an hour from now, 9 o'clock, on all the major networks. Couldn't do it during the shutdown, but now the shutdown's on hold, so the State of the Union address tonight from Washington, D.C. Two balls, two strikes, Luke Boykin at the plate. Lakewood leads the pitch. Popped up high behind home plate. Catcher looking, and it's out of play. And Luke Boykin will come back to home plate. Count remaining two balls, two strikes. And Luke Boykin, the younger brother, Griffin Boykin. They got a younger brother, Max Boykin. Look out. Major League All-Star potential, Max Boykin.
Got a batter right here, Wong!
Two balls, two strikes. The stretch, the pitch. Up high, ball three, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, 7-1 ball game. Wayne County leads it here in the scrimmage. The payoff pitch. High and deep, but foul and out of play. Boy, he turned all over that. Full count, three balls, two strikes. 7-1. Three balls, two strikes. The payoff pitch. Swung on and foul back. And Luke and Griffin's grandfather, James Boykin, still come to the ballpark. Good to see him. And we talk about somebody who's done a lot for this ballpark and Wayne County Athletics in general. Got to put him up at the top of the list for everything he's done for Wayne County Athletics. Good to see the commissioner. Used to be a commissioner. I call him commish. But a great man, James Boykin. Watching his two grandsons here. This is one of them at the plate, Luke Boykin. Been watching Griffin the last couple of years on a varsity level, but now Luke joins him. So, but he's all bundled up there over on that first base side. Good to see him here. Payoff pitch, three balls, two strikes, the 3-2 pitch, and popped up third base side, third baseman waiting for it to come down, makes the catch, and there's one down. One out in the sixth for Wayne County. And coming to the plate, number 16, Miles Starlin. This is Gant's younger brother.
Hey, number 16.
I don't know what Miles is eating, but I got to get some of it. I'll tell you what, this kid is a big kid. Him and Owen Spell both. I don't know what kind of diet they're on, but I got to get some of what they're eating because they are some big youngsters. Big and strong. Miles Starlin and Owen Spell. See, Miles, what class is Miles? And is he a freshman as well? Yeah, Miles is a freshman. Miles Starlin. This kid's come a long way, I tell you. Talk about a kid that's worked and gotten better and better. He's a good-looking athlete. Just a freshman. No telling his potential. Here's the stretch and the pitch. In for a strike. No balls. One strike. So Luke Boykin, freshman, seeing some action. Miles Starlin, freshman, seeing some action. You got Trey Pierce on the roster as a freshman. Getting some talented kids in this baseball program. The stretch and the pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two to Miles Starlin. 0-2. 7-1, Wayne County. Again, just two hits allowed by Wayne County pitching here in the scrimmage against Vidalia. That's the good story. The 0-2 pitch, call strike three, and Miles gets caught looking. Two down.
And number 20, Ray Townsend.
Here's Ray Townsend. Ray Townsend at the plate, two down, a runner at first base. 7-1 game in favor of Wayne County. Curious to see who is to the mound in the seventh inning. Got another arm yet to see. Here's the pitch. It is down low, bounces away from the catcher and down to second base goes Blake Wood. One ball, no strikes. One ball, no strikes, two outs. Here's the stretch and the pitch. And the pitcher resets. Let's see, possibility for the seventh inning. Haven't seen Ty Anderson, could see him. Haven't seen Cooper. Cooper could pitch the seventh. Those are two possibilities. Trey Pierce, he could possibly pitch. Be interested to see who they send out there in inning number seven. There's the pitch. And for a strike, 1-1 to Ray Townsend. And Bryce Startup, good two innings by him. We saw Ray Townsend for an inning, Sean Steverson for an inning, Jasper Stanfield. There's the pitch, and it's down low, ball two, 2-1. Two balls, one strike, two outs. A 2-1 pitch. And it's down low, ball three, 3-1. Three balls, one strike, the pitch, and for strike two, 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, bottom of the sixth, game scheduled for seven, Wayne 7, Vidalia 1. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Call strike three. Inning comes to a close. In the inning, Wayne comes up empty. No runs, no hits, no errors. A runner left on base. We head to the final frame, the seventh, with Wayne leading it by a score of 7-1.
Restaurant is open 7 days a week and offers daily specials and has a wide variety of menu items from salads to wings to burgers and fries, and check out their famous turkey burger. Damon's is famous for their variety of sauces, mild, wild, insane, or inferno. When it comes to party platters, Damon's can make your party special. Simply call in the order ahead of time by calling 588-WING, 588-9464. Damon's Famous Fingers and Wings continues to please its customers, and if you're looking for a great meal any day of the week, stop by and enjoy Damon's. You stop in or use the drive-thru at the location 336 West Cherry Street. That's Damon's Restaurant at Wayne County favorite.
Wayne Memorial Hospital wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck as they pursue region and state championships. The hard work and dedication of our coaches and student athletes has been instrumental to your success. The staff at Wayne Memorial Hospital is also dedicated to providing and delivering the best possible health care to everyone who comes through our doors. We consider it an honor and a privilege to be entrusted with your health care needs. Caring for the community isn't just our motto, it's what we love to do. Wayne Memorial Hospital, the official healthcare provider of the Yellow Jackets.
At Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors. Custom landscape design, including sod installation, shrubs and trees, bedding plants, unique hardscapes, seating areas, fire pits, archway entrances, and pavers. Design Landscaping can also do sprinkler systems, fencing, and more. Call Ryan Madry at Design Landscaping, 678-347-6136, 678-347-6136. On Facebook, Design Landscaping, Instagram, Design_Landscaping. Design Landscaping, we bring life outdoors.
Wayne County Baseball, brought to you by Southeast Georgia Garage Door. Call 266-6567, 266-6567, Southeast Georgia Garage Door.
We head to the seventh inning, the last frame. And we're going to see another freshman pitcher, another lefty out there, Brad Irati. Had a good outing on Fun Day, started off pitching for one of the teams, and he's on the mound here in the seventh. And the pitch is up high, ball one. 1-0, Brad Irati, another freshman lefty, on the mound here to close out the game against Vidalia. The scrimmage, 7-1, has a nice six-run cushion, so I'm sure all they want to do is throw strikes, get three outs, and wrap this baby up. Here's the wind and the pitch, and it's down low, ball two, 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. Wayne County's Brad Irati. This is my sidekick on Friday night, son Joe Irati. I know he's excited. Two balls, no strikes. A 2-0 pitch. And that's in for a strike, 2-1. And he throws hard, big, tall lefty. Only a freshman, so he's got a lot of potential as well if he keeps on growing, which I'm sure he will. A 2-1 pitch, in for strike two, 2-2. Good looking pitch right there. Two balls, two strikes, so Brad battles back from a 2-0 to 2-2, see if he can get an out here, a strikeout. Here's the wind and the pitch. Swing, did he get him? He did, struck him out. Brad Irati's first batter on varsity level in a scrimmage is a strikeout for the young freshman. So a good way to start your varsity baseball career. Here's Carson Spivey. Good job. Three straight strikes after 2-0 count. So one down. Here's the wind, the pitch. It's down low, ball one. 1-0. One thing I noticed about him on Fun Day, he keeps everything low, which is a good sign, bound around the knees. It's a big, tall lefty. Throws hard. One ball and no strikes. The pitch up high, ball two, 2-0. Two balls, no strikes, one out. We're in the seventh final frame of this scrimmage. Wayne County leads it 7-1. Freshman Brad Irati on the mound. The pitch up high, ball three, 3-1. Three balls, one strike. The 3-1 pitch just missed outside. and it's a one-out walk.
And number 25, Anthony Walker.
Anthony Walker comes to the plate for Vidalia. Had a double play ball. Yeah, let's get the double play ball in this ball game. Stretching the pitch. And it's down low, ball 1-1-0. You ready? One ball and no strikes, one out. The 1-0 pitch. Swung on and foul back, 1-1. One ball, one strike, one down. Stay tuned for the Country Financial postgame show. We'll get Coach McDonald, get his thoughts on this scrimmage and his thoughts on the upcoming 2019 baseball season, which kicks off on Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. The 1-1 pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. Nice little breaking pitch there by Brad Irati. 1-2 to count. One ball, two strikes, one down.
Get him right here, kid. Get him.
Ahead in the count. See if he can get another strikeout here. The 1-2 pitch. Steps off and sends the runner back to first base. 1 ball, two strikes, one down. The 1-2 pitch. Outside, ball two, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Brad Irati, lefty on the mound, the 2-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Second strikeout for Brad Irati. There's one out to go here in a scrimmage.
And number 10, Jordan Walden.
Jordan Walden at the plate for Vide. One out to go for Wayne County. Brad Irati with two strikeouts. Stretching the pitch. In for a strike. No balls, one strike. Good looking pitch. No balls, one strike, two outs. Brad Irati on the mound. The stretch in the 0-1 pitch. Popped him up. This should do it. Griffin Boykin drifts out on the grass, says it's his, and he's got it. And that's your ball game. Final score, Wayne County 7, Vidalia 1. Stay tuned for the Country Financial postgame show. Come your way next. Well, I take it back. It looks like they're going to let Wayne County bat. Is that what we're doing? I take it back. They're going to let Wayne County bat here in the bottom of the 7th. So we don't have the end of the game. So we'll be back with the bottom of the 7th after the timeout.
Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop is proud to be sponsoring Wayne County Yellow Jacket Baseball and wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck this baseball season. Sheffield's has all your Under Armour winter and cold gear as they are the new Under Armour provider in this area. Sheffield's has all you need to outfit your team, bats, balls, caps, jackets, you name it, they've got it. Sheffield's is located 1516 West Orange Street and has everything you need when it comes to sporting goods. Stop by or give them a call today. The number is 427-2982. Sheffield's Trophies and Sports Shop wishing the Yellow Jackets the best of luck all season. Mobile Concrete in Jessup wishes the Yellow Jackets the best of luck in today's game and wants everyone to know that no job is too big or small for Mobile Concrete. Mobile Concrete has locations in Jessup, Baxley, Brunswick, Glenville, Hinesville, Darien, and Ahoney, Georgia. Located at 1705 Highway 341 South in Jessup, just past Neesmith Chevrolet on the left. 7 plant locations with 25 mixtures. Give Mobile Concrete a call today at 427-2330. Mobile Concrete says go Wayne County.
If you're a small business owner, you know what you mean to your customers. You're the local pro, a neighborhood problem solver, a person in their community they know will treat them right. State Farm agents are no different, and I'm Robin Eubanks, and I own a small business too. So I'm perfectly positioned to understand your needs and help you protect your small business. Stop in today and see me for your small business insurance. And as a longtime supporter of the Wayne County Yellow Jackets, we wish you a winning year.
Wayne County Baseball brought to you by Napa Auto Parts, 455 South 1st Street, Jessup. Call 427-2095, 427-2095.
So it appears Wayne County is going to get the bat here in the bottom of seven. Again, it's just a scrimmage, so I guess both teams are going to get their full seven innings of work here. So Wayne County will bat here in the bottom of seven, but I should end it after this. It is a school night, so I'm sure they want to get these kids out of here and get them ready for school the next day. Miguel Vail says we need to cut the lights off, save some electricity here. 7-1 game. Here's the wind, the pitch, and swing and a miss. Jacob Brewer at the plate for Wayne County. Again, 7-1, Wayne. Kevin Cox, the pitcher now for Vidalia. Bottom of the seventh again. Scrimmage, so both teams going to get the bat. Their full seven innings. Pitch called a ball. That was a good-looking pitch. One ball, one strike. Again, stay tuned for Country Financial postgame show here from Coach McDonald. Get his thoughts on the scrimmage and the upcoming season, which gets underway Monday. Swung on and fouled back by Jacob Brewer. One ball, two strikes, 7-1 game. And just two hits for Vidalia in the scrimmage. That's the good news for Wayne County pitching. One ball, two strikes. Popped up foul out of play. Yeah, scrimmage is just what it is. Scrimmage, get people in there. So they've got a lot of the freshmen in there tonight. Seen Miles Starlin bat. Seen Brad Arati pitch. Saw Luke Boykin bat. So three freshmen made an appearance thus far in the scrimmage. Saw sophomore Ray Townsend on the mound, Blake Wood on the mound, sophomore. Zach Thomas, a sophomore. There's a little pop-up, second baseman out on the grass. Right fielder comes in, the right fielder comes in, makes the catch, and there's one down. One away, bottom of seventh, brings up Sean Steverson.
And number two, Sean Steverson.
Pitches down low, ball one, 1-0. 7-1 game in favor of Wayne County here tonight against Vidalia. Here's the wind, the pitch. And the down low, ball two, 2-0. Sean Steverson at the plate, one down, bottom of the seventh. Wayne County 7, Vidalia 1. Here's the wind, the pitch, in for a strike, 2-1. Two balls, one strike, one out. 2-1 pitch. Is down low, ball 3-1. Three balls, one strike, one down. Bottom of the seventh, Wayne County getting their seventh inning at bat here in this scrimmage. 3-1 pitch, strike 2-2. Three balls, two strikes, one out. 3-2 pitch, ball four, walked. And that brings up Bryce Miller.
Hey, number 19, Bryce Miller.
And Perkins on deck, stretching the pitch. Down low, gets by the catcher, and the runner hit to second base. One ball, no strikes, one out. Bottom of the seventh, Wayne 7, Vidalia 1. The pitch
in for a strike, 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out. The 1-1. Ball 2-1. Two balls, one strike. The 2-1 pitch. Ball 3-1. Three balls, one strike, one out. And as I side, ball 4, another walk. Brings up Hamp Perkins for Wayne County. Hamp had a base hit his last time up, 1-for-3 on the night.
And number 18, Hamp Perkins.
Seven one in favor of Wayne County. Batting here in the bottom of the seventh inning, 2 on, 1 down. Pitch is outside, ball 1-0. One ball, no strikes, one out. The 1-0 pitch. Up high, ball 2-0. Two balls, no strikes, one out. Scrimmage now at a turtle pace trying to get these final outs here. The 2-0 down low, ball 3-0. As the walk-a-thon is underway here. Two walks in a row, about to walk a third batter. Three balls, no strikes, one out. In for a strike, 3-1. Three balls, one strike, one out. The 3-1. Little ground ball is short. Shortstop has it, throws to first, throws low. First baseman can't handle it. All hands safe, bases loaded, one out. The and Cooper comes to the plate.
Number 14.
So a 7-1 game can turn into a blowout here. That's what I'm saying. Why are we playing this final inning is what I don't understand, but whatever. No balls or one ball, no strike to Cooper. Where's the wind, the pitch? And it's outside, ball 2-0. Two balls, no strikes, the pitch. Ball 3-0. We might be here all night getting these final 2 outs, folks. Thought we were going to get to see the president's speech at 9, but the way it's going, we'll be lucky. And 7-1, pretty much the final of the scrimmage. This is just Wayne County getting the bat and some pitching work for Vidalia, but this pitcher's struggling big time. Three balls, no strikes, bases loaded. The pitch. In for a strike, 3-1. Every time it's 3-0, he can throw it right down the heart. Why don't they just think it's 3-0 every time? 3-1, this will probably be a ball. Nope,
swung on and fouled back, 3-2. Full count, two outs to go to end this scrimmage. Wayne leads at 7-1, bases loaded. One down. 3 balls, 2 strikes. The 3-2 pitch. And that's laced in the left field and could clear the bases. 2 runs in, runner come to third. They're going to hold him there. Wayne's got 2 more runs in. And it's runners at 2nd and 3rd.
And number 10, Griffin Boykin.
So Griffin Boykin comes to the plate. So all the walks have come home to score. And Griffin rips one in the left field for a base hit. And 2 more runs come in for Wayne County. Makes it an 11-1 game here for Wayne. And we're still looking for 2 more outs. Here's Blake Wood.
And number 4, Blake Wood.
Fly ball to right. This could be an out. Right fielder is there. 2 down. So 1 out to go. Again, stay tuned for the Country Financial Post Game Show. Comes your way after the broadcast. And Luke Boykin bats here with 2 down. Runner at first base. Here's the stretch and the pitch. And it's down low, ball 1-0. One ball, no strikes, 2 outs. One ball, no strikes, 2 outs. The stretch and the pitch. Grounded foul, 1-1. 1 ball, 1 strike, 2 outs. Freshman Luke Boykin at the plate. Here's the stretch and the pitch. And it's down low, bounces away from the catcher. Runner goes to 2nd base. One count to the batter, Luke Boykin. Line, base hit, right center field. Griffin will score. Luke will hold at first base. 12-1 Wayne County. And brings up Miles Starlin.
And number 16, Miles Starlin.
Stretching the pitch, and there's a line drive left center field in for a base hit. Runners at 1st and 2nd. Big hit by Miles Starlin. Brings up Ray Townsend.
And number 20, Ray Townsend.
Well, if they wanted to get this pitcher work, they're getting him some work. He's probably throwing about 40 pitches. Sorry. That pitch is up high, ball 1-0.
Again, Country Financial postgame show coming your way as soon as we get this final out here in this scrimmage. Swung on and foul back, 1-1. Again, first game Monday in Brunswick, Georgia, 5:50 pregame, 6 o'clock first pitch. Ray Townsend to plate, Miles Starlin and Luke Boykin on base, the 1-1. Ball 2-1. Two balls, one strike, the pitch. Down low, ball 3-1. Three balls, one strike, two outs, 3-1. Call strike 2-2. Payoff pitch. Runners will be off on the pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that's your ball game. Final score, Wayne 11, Vidalia 1. Country Financial postgame show comes your way next year on Big Dog Country, FM 105.5. We'll hear from Coach McDonald. We'll get his thoughts on the game.
Boykin and Boykin Steel and Crane wish the Yellow Jackets the best of luck this season, and Boykin Steel and Crane's legacy will make your foundation stronger as they specialize in steel fabrication, industrial maintenance, steel erection, crane rentals, and concrete. Boykin Steel and Crane in operation in Justin and Wayne County since 1972. Jim Boykin has taken over the family business and continues to do what's best for his community. Boykin Steel and Crane located on the Savannah Highway in Jessup. The number to call is 427-7751. Boykin Steel and Crane, again, wishing the Yellow Jackets the best of luck.
Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue, now open 823 North 1st Street, 6 a.m. until 9 p.m., 6 days a week. They offer dine-in and drive-thru for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. In addition, catering, delivery, and fundraisers. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue. Stop by or call 912-385-2657, 385-2657 for fast pickup service. Hog and Bones Breakfast and Barbecue supports Wayne County Baseball. Go Jackets!
Finding the right house starts with REMAX.com, featuring millions of properties just waiting to be called home. With all types of listings, we'll recommend what's right for you. That's the sign of a REMAX agent. Visit REMAX.com to find your home and agent now. Each office independently owned and operated.
Life is a series of moves as your goals and dreams change. So for life's moving moments, call me, Peggy Hickey, your local REMAX agent at 912-614-7546, and I will make that move easy for you.
When you become a customer at Prime South Bank, you become part of a team that has your back and is with you every step of the way in achieving your financial goals. Our doors opened in 1891. 125 years later, we are still going strong. Prime South is constantly bringing innovative and convenient banking solutions to our growing communities. And our customers, well, they are the real MVPs. In the bank or on the field, Prime South's game face is always on for you. Prime South Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
To Jacket Post Game, brought to you by Sean O'Quinn, your Country Financial Representative.
And welcome back. Coach McDonald making his way up here to the press box as Wayne County wraps up this scrimmage here on a Tuesday night. And the beginning of the season gets underway Monday down in Brunswick, Georgia. We'll take on the Pirates at 6 o'clock on Monday. We'll have that game for you, have all the games for you here on Big Dog Country, FM 105.5. But again, scrimmage did exactly what Coach McDonald wanted to do. Saw a lot of good arms out there for Wayne County, a couple of freshman arms as well. And again, win this scrimmage easily over Vidalia, 7-1 after regulation, but Wayne got the bat in the bottom of the seventh and put on some extra runs to make it a final of 11-1 if you wanted to give the official 11-1 final. But either way, Wayne County won it. The pitching is the impressive thing. A lot of good arms. Bryce Miller started it. So Ray Townsend, Sean Steverson, Brad Arati, Blake Wood. And again, Wayne County's pitching looked very, very good here in this scrimmage. Again, Wayne County wins it. We're waiting for Coach McDonald to make his way up here to the box and get his thoughts on this ball game, and then we'll wrap it up here. Again, appreciate Country Financial, Sean O'Quinn, being our post-game sponsor. And here's Coach McDonald. We'll get his thoughts on this scrimmage and get him out here on this school night. But, Coach, again, the scrimmage did exactly what you wanted to do. Got to see a lot of arms, a lot of kids. Got to be happy with the results.
Yeah, we did. We kind of our mentality, throw a guy in, and then Bryce had a real quick inning, so he got to throw another one. But like I said, that was an outstanding job defensively. We had one little blunder there that cost us a run, but otherwise put pretty solid on defense. And I think offensively we was trying to do a little too much early, kind of, I guess, first game here playing against somebody else. It kind of took advantage of us with that, but we settled in and had some great at-bats.
Well, the good thing is, like I said, you threw a bunch of arms and a couple of freshman arms as well. They only got two hits the entire night, so that's the good news. A lot of strikeouts as well. So got to see a lot of kids play, but your thoughts on how the kids performed overall?
I think we did well. You know, it's a process, and, you know, we're still piecing this thing together, and we're still banged up in the dugout a little bit too, so injury-wise, but we got to get everybody healthy and get them rolling at the same time. But our philosophy in that locker room, we got 37 guys in there, and it's going to take all 37 to make this thing happen. And that's the mentality we have. And again, it's all about finding out what your role is this season and accepting it and moving on.
Schedule next week, it begins in Brunswick Monday night and then the weekend in Jeff Davis. Anything in between there?
We play, we're on the road against Brunswick on Monday, and we play here at home against Brantley on Tuesday.
On Tuesday, okay.
And then we'll go play at 2 and 4:30, and Jeff Davis will play Jones first, Jeff Davis second. So
okay, so it's Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday at home next week, and then on the road at Jeff Davis.
Weekend, and we'll have JV games both Wednesday and Thursday. I think Wednesday's at home, and then Thursday's on the road. So six games in our program next week, and to try to get six wins.
Okay, sounds good, Coach. Well, congrats on the win here in scrimmage. Like I said, I see a lot of freshmen. I was impressed. You got a lot of talent in the younger age group. To see two freshmen step out of the line, pitch well, you had to be happy about that.
We did, and you know, it's going. Our philosophy of the coaching staff is get those guys as much experience as we can right now. And I know the two of them come in and have very good at bats there in that bottom of the seventh that we got to play, which you know he had an extra arm to throw, and we'll take advantage of it, getting those guys at bats and allowing them to grow as players. And you know, the next time they get into this kind of setting, they already been there. So that's what it's about, is getting experience. And you can't put a price tag on experience when it comes to high school baseball at the varsity level. So again, proud of our guys, and look, we're going to get these guys in there, get them ready to go to the basketball game tomorrow night, support the basketball program. And you know, Coach Ray's done a great job. It's going to be a fun week to be a support another team. And I know our guys are looking forward to that Wednesday and Friday.
Okay, Coach. Congrats.
Appreciate it, Bob.
That's going to do it for the Country Financial Postgame Show. Again, Wayne County beats Vidalia here. Thanks to Jonathan. Thanks to our sponsors. Thanks to our listeners. Again, Monday, Tuesday, and the weekend next week. The Tuesday game's at home against Brantley County here next Tuesday. So that's the first home game, the first road game against the Brunswick Pirates. That's going to do it for the broadcast. Until tomorrow morning for local news, local sports, Bob Morgan saying so long, everybody. Have a great night.
You've been listening to Wayne County Baseball. You in part by Jones Medical Equipment, Lighty's Body Shop, Damon's Famous Fingers and Wings, Wayne Memorial Hospital, Sheffield's Trophy and Sports Shop, Mobile Concrete, State Farm Agent Robin Eubanks, Sheriff John Carter, Boykin Steel and Crane, Hog and Bones, April Banks Remax, Prime South Bank, the Interstate Credit Union, Tim's Home Medical, Top Notch Lawn Care, Hurricane's Convenience Store, Heating and Air Co., the Altamaha Federal Credit Union, and Design Landscaping.